Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Lions Field for today's ball game between the Bobcats of Plymouth High School and your Goffstown Grizzlies. Along with Paul Hunt, I'm Mike Santoro. We're going to bring in a play-by-play today. Paul's going to give you the starting lineup. Paul?
Well, I'll tell you what, another beautiful day for baseball, Mike, as the Grizzlies take the field. And defensively, what we have right now, you're going to see Ethan Smith. He'll be leading off, but he'll be playing second base. Clay Campbell, I'll tell you what a surprise he's been this year. Maybe not for some, but I think he's done an excellent job stepping right in. There's a sophomore playing shortstop. You have Connor Hyzak. This kid's a freshman. He's done exceptionally well. He's on the bump today. It's his second outing. His first outing, he was stellar. There was no freshman jitters, no first game jitters with that kid right there. Cody Morrell, the staple at third base in Goffstown baseball since Little League. He's wearing number 8 and playing third base. Our catching today, batting number 5th. 5 is Jacob Hunt, 18. Again, been around forever in Goffstown baseball. Playing under you, Mike, for so many years, as has Cody. And then the next kid, another one, Matt Woodward, number 21, playing right field for Goffstown Grizzlies. Another one, been around Goffstown baseball since he's been 7. Starting today, making his first start, is Nick Labrie, playing first. He's done very well. I believe he's a sophomore, if I'm not mistaken. And then we have Peter Hunt playing outfield and batting 9th. We have Carter Schwinnard, who's done very well defensively for the Goffstown Grizzlies.
Great job, Paul, as we watch Connor taking his warm-up tosses. I believe Nick is a junior. Nick's a junior. He's been around for a while. As you said, most of these guys, born and bred in Goffstown, we've coached them all through the ranks from T-ball all the way up, watched them go through Little League, Senior League, Babe Ruth, and even Legion. So one more pitch. Jake's going to throw the ball down, and we'll get underway. As you said, Paul, beautiful day, probably about 75 degrees. Wind, you can see Old Glory out there blowing slightly out, slight breeze.
Well, I'll tell you what, considering the way the year's been, that first game we froze. We've already had a rain out. And then the weather's not looking too good for Wednesday, but today, I'll take it. This is mid-season baseball.
Yeah, it certainly is. We also have Nate in the booth with us today. You'll hear him once in a while on the loudspeaker. He'll be doing our in-game broadcasting. All right, and here we go. First pitch of our season. First home game for the Grizzlies. First pitch up a little high, ball 1.
I'll tell you, Mike, Plymouth is a pretty young ball club right now, and they're playing pretty solid baseball. And right now they're facing a hot Grizzly team.
Second pitch, swing and a miss, strike 1. 1-1 to count. Mike Hogan is our first batter. He'll be playing third base today. A little low. 2-1 count. As you said, Paul, Connor, a freshman, making his second start of the season. A little bit inside.
If you notice, Connor, he strides out well, nice balance, great follow through, and this kid's a freshman. And right now he plays very well for such a young kid.
Fouled out of play, probably into the river. We should get somebody in a kayak out there, Paul, like they do in San Francisco.
I'm not your guy out there.
Swing and another foul. Count remains full.
Nice crowd out there. A lot of people travel from Plymouth. We know it's about, 60 miles away, hour drive, and they have a good showing out there.
Here comes the pitch. Ooh, and it hit him right on the 3. So an inauspicious start there for Connor. Count went full, wasted a strike, wasted a good pitch, and then took one right on the 3. So a man on first base. We have Owen Brickley now, the batter, stepping in. Owen will be playing second base today for the Bobcats. Hogan gets his lead off first base and a check on him. Back very easily. Brickley looking down to third for the sign. Steps back in, squaring the bunt, and then pulls it back takes a pitch high for a ball. See that, Paul? Cody was about 30 feet away from home plate by the time that was all said and done.
He's well coached since age 7.
He's about 15 feet into the grass at third base right now. Squaring again early. Yep, again pitches high. Jake boxes it around a little bit, but recovers it pretty quickly. 2-0 count. Connor seems to be a bit high with some of his pitches so far today.
He does. He'll get that release point back down. First home game.
Another pitch up high. Then we get a 3-0 count. Jake calls time to go speak with him. Just to calm the freshman down.
That's all it is.
Like you say, he's got some nerves out there. First home game. Pretty big crowd, like you said. I mean, we can see the Plymouth folks from here, and that's a pretty good contingent out there.
Connor will do well. He'll get back into that breathe and throw mode, bring that ball down. He'll do well. I have faith, Mike.
Oh, yeah. First inning. 3-0, I'm sure he'll be taking here. Right down the middle. 3-1 count. It's actually a good pitch to run on right here. 3-1.
3-1.
You run, ball four, you just keep, you know, and walk in and maybe get something. See, and Connor knows. He steps off just to see if he plays, gives his hand out a
little
bit.
Absolutely. Gives your catcher a chance if you hold that runner at first.
Not going. Swing and a miss. Count is full for the second time. Now, again, we'll see if they start up Hogan here. Brickley as a second batter is probably a good contact guy. Runner stays, and he hit him.
Wow.
So he's gone to two full counts, and he's hit the first two batters.
That's shocking.
Now batting number 7, Dylan Donahue.
Sure is. I mean, I know it's he's got some jitters there. You know, he's already up, 12 pitches so far in the first inning. And Jake, again, doing his job, going out to settle his freshman down. Don't want it to be overthrowing. Going to get that release point down.
Absolutely.
I mean, now that 3-0 count, those next two pitches were right down. I mean, those were right where you want them to be. So Jake, again, doing what he needs to do. The batter got hit, going out there, giving him a little extra time. That's experience. That's a senior catcher out there doing what he needs to do.
Right now we have Dylan Donahue coming up. He's a shortstop, number 7 for Plymouth. Number 3 hitter.
Big wide stance on him. Trying to keep the runners close. Here comes the pitch. Swing and a miss. Good pitch. Low and in. Good pitch right there.
Wind's blowing slightly out to right.
Yep.
Nothing too crazy.
All the outfield's playing straight away.
Straight away.
Not too deep. And there's a fly ball. Schwinnard circles under it and makes the grab.
We have one down.
Now batting number 11, Garrett DeMoss.
It's a good pitch there. First and second, number 3 hitter come out, came right after him, threw two good strikes. Got a can of corn pop up.
Well, number 11, Garrett DeMoss, he's the number 4 hitter, and he's also their pitcher today.
Runners are fairly close on the base. That looks like a strike. Good pitch on the outside part of the plate. So after that second hit batsman, Connor's throwing 3 strikes in a row, so could be finding that groove.
That's right.
Settling down, as you said. Nice pitch.
There you go.
Foul tip at the plate. Now he's ahead of him 0-2. See what he does here. He hasn't thrown any off-speed pitches yet because he's been struggling with that fastball. So see what he does here.
Keep the ball down. Maybe get a ground ball.
Yep. Trust your catcher. Throw the ball down. Don't be afraid to throw a curve or something off-speed. There it is.
That's
nice curveball right there in the dirt. Boxed around a little bit. Runner takes off for third base, and he makes it. So now we got a first and third situation. We'll see how Plymouth handles this. Got your 4-hole hitter, less than 2 outs, man on third base. He's going to look to drive
something
here. He's going
to look to, right.
Here. Runner at first base. Comes another off-speed pitch. Mitch is this high.
That was close.
Yep.
Disciplined hitter there to stay off that.
Yep. He saw it coming. Now he's looking probably dead red. 2-2 count here. Although we could still throw another off-speed pitch, but I don't know if you want to go for. Oh, the runner leaning.
Leaning. They're looking to get that man 90 feet, and it's a scoring position, maybe?
Sure. Well, maybe open a hole, too. Yep. If Ethan's going to go over and cover, that opens a hole. He just wants to try to push the ball to the right side to drive the runner in. There goes the runner. Nice curveball in the dirt. No throw.
Let him go. No throw.
Struck him out. Two outs. That's a great pitch right there.
That's just what you want right there.
He's looking fastball. Doesn't get it.
Now batting number 14, Patrick Malm.
Here comes the right fielder, Patrick Malm. Second and third, two outs. First pitch. Kind of fist that one foul. Oh, Patrick must be used to the cold weather. He's got a hooded sweatshirt on.
It's a beautiful one. 79, 80 degrees today.
Patrick didn't get the memo today, I guess. Kind of hurt his hand on that swing. Jammed him good.
Jammed him up.
Kind of steps off. Resets here. He's one pitch away from getting out of this inning. Way late on a fastball. Fouls it into his bench. 0-2. Number five hitter was way late on that fastball. I say you do the same thing. Don't mess around. But you could buckle his knees with a curveball right here.
It worked last time.
Here comes the pitch. Nope, he goes high with the fastball. That's okay. Change that eye level. You went high with one. Now this is maybe where you come with the curveball. Again, you got Jake Hunt, who's a senior catcher back there. Gives him a low and inside signal. Here's the pitch.
There you go.
Oh. Strike three. Ball gets away. Jake's going to make the throw. And he does. So Plymouth threatens but does not score. They have two runners. They leave two runners via hit batsmen both. And we had a fly out to center and two strikeouts.
24 pitches, Mike.
24 pitches in the first. Again, I think he just had to get the jitters out.
First home day for everybody, so hopefully they'll shake it off. And now we'll come up with Ethan Smith can be leading off for us. So let's get it started, as they say.
Yeah. So as you said, we have Garrett DeMas on the mound, number 11. And behind the dish, we have Ben Olmsted, number 12.
Ben Olmsted's caught every pitch. I do know this about him as a catcher. He's caught every pitch since he's been brought up 2 years ago. And he was part of the team that right after they played us in the state championship is when he came up, took over the catching duties for Plymouth.
He's been rock solid back there.
He's a good defensive catcher. It's what I have on this kid. Good arm.
Let's see if we can put some pressure on him early. DeMas looks like a big kid. Throws a couple different pitches from what I see there warming up.
Yeah, he's a nice finish. Good balance, right?
Yep.
He stretches out.
His first pitch was high, but since then he's been right in the strike zone. See how the boys handle him.
And I'm sure, you know, for Plymouth, here they come into us. You know, you'd be playing an undefeated team in Goffstown. And right now we've kind of almost beat ourselves the first couple of times, Mike, with some errors and, you know, jitters. But we've come through. Mitch Skocke has actually done a great job. French has done a great job pitching. So it's been nice to see them. They've made some errors, but they didn't let it get to them.
Right.
And they held it together and they came through with some victories.
Yep, and Matt Woodward pitched the gem.
Oh, 10 strikeouts, right?
Against Pembroke. And as Paul was saying, we get 13-4 victory over Merrimack Valley. On their first game of the year, and then they beat Bow 6-3. And then, as we were just talking about, they beat Pembroke 4-0. Here comes Ethan Smith. Ethan, he gets on base. You got to watch out for him. He's got way above average speed.
He loves Mookie Betts. Let's see if he can pull a Mookie Betts right here for us.
Why not? First pitch, let's go deep. First pitch, swings in the hole, the short, up throw, way high, overthrows. That's going to go to the fence and get retrieved by the first baseman, and Ethan ends up on second base. That's a good start.
Good hustle. Right out of the box, it went to the shortstop, and I think when you have somebody going as fast as Smitty does down that first baseline.
Now batting number 14, Clay Campbell.
That puts some pressure on that shortstop to get rid of that ball.
Sure does. He did. He had some time. He's got a good arm over there, and he just airmailed it. That'll be an E6 if you're scoring at home.
Clay Campbell is filled in just nicely. It plays middle infield, shortstop, and second, depends on who's pitching.
Takes first pitch high and outside. Yeah, Clay's job right here, hit the ball to the right side. Got to get that runner to third base. If you're going to make an out, make a productive out. No sign of a bunt. Pitch in the dirt. Good stop there. Ben with a nice stop.
It was. Defensively sound.
Takes ball three outside, 3-0.
Well, for this young pitcher, it's a position he doesn't want to get in now.
Nope. Not with who's looming large. You got the meat of the order coming up.
That 3, 4, and 5, they can hit the ball, so.
I think Clay's taken all the way here. And he is. Pitches in there for strike. 3-1 count. Again, he's looking dead red. He's looking for something he can pull. There comes the pitch. There it is. There's
That's
a base hit.
Right
field.
Moving 90.
Something he can base pull.
Hit.
He's on first. Smitty makes the turn. Good throw in.
Now batting number 5, Connor Hyzak.
And we got first and third, no outs.
I'll tell you what, Mike. Connor is a freshman. He's been a pleasure. We've watched him, again, pitch coming up through Goffstown Junior Baseball, and he's continued right where he left off in that small field.
Yeah, he has. The catcher, Olmstead, yells out 29, telling his infield what he's going to do with the ball. Should Campbell take off? Campbell with the pretty average lead there. No look, no throw. Pitch outside, low for a ball. Infield's playing double play depth. Although Connor's going to be a tough guy to double up again with good speed. Excellent speed on the bases right now. Campbell bluffs, and there's a long drive to center field. Center fielder going back. It's over his head. It one hops the wall. Campbell rounding second. Hyzak right behind him at second base. Campbell in easily to third, and Hyzak stands in safely with the double.
Great
it's
hit.
1-0 Goffstown.
Very patient. You know we hit the ball well when that went away straight away center.
Cody Morrell.
Yeah, the center fielder took a step in, and that ball went right over his head. That ball got out there in a hurry.
First step in outfield is backwards, but he came in forward.
He did. So now we get second and third for Cody Morrell.
Cody has been real hot. He's been hitting the ball solid. Right center field last few times.
Yeah, and look at that gap in right center field right now. If he sees that, first pitch curveball fouled away.
You know, I can understand that. I know Cody's probably sitting dead red right there.
Yep, not a bad idea. Like I said, you trust your catcher. Still have excellent speed on the bases. Campbell at third, Hyzak at second. There's the pitch, fastball up high. 1-1 to Cody.
Cody's nickname is Moose. It's because he's been the biggest kid on the field since he's been 7. And you look at him now, works out like crazy. Great number 3, 4, or 5 hitter, lefty.
Off-speed pitch again. Moose lays off that one. Tried it again. He got him to swing at the first one. Cody was looking for a fastball right away. Got the curve again there. And now it's 2-1. He's got to be careful here. Cody's looking fastball. He gets it, and he fouls it off. Kind of jammed himself a little bit on that one.
He did. But you can tell by the look at Cody right now. He knows it.
Yep.
He's a good enough ball player that he'll come in and make the adjustment.
Yep. So, again, 2-2 count. He's already thrown 2 curveballs. Wouldn't be surprised to see one here. I'm sure Cody's thinking the same. And there it is in
there
the dirt.
Is.
Nice stop. Full count now. And you really don't want to load the bases up with Jake coming on deck, coming up next.
Well, you know he's going to give him that fastball. So yeah. He's got to love this thing right here.
Yep. And again, something he can drive, get that runner in anyway. And Cody calls time. Doesn't like how much time that DeMoss has taken out there. This has all the earmarks of a big inning so far.
We need some crooked numbers.
We sure do. Here comes the pitch, fastball. Oh, and he gets him on strike three looking. Something you don't see Cody do very often, no. I'll tell you that.
He must have just seen that coming from the inside and just didn't like it.
Now batting number 18, Jake Hunt.
Unless Cody just outguessed himself. Maybe he's thinking curveball again. I don't know.
That's possible. That's possible.
I just don't see him take that pitch. Now it's up to Jake. Second and third, one out. Got to get the ball in play. Force him to make a play. Takes a pretty high high strike. That's okay if you're up there with the strike, as long as that's the way it is the whole game. Although Jake is a big kid, 6'3". There's the pitch, off-speed pitch, foul straight back.
Don't want to see Jake get a little over-anxious here.
No.
You know, with second and third, first is open.
Again, he's going to trust his catcher. Got to look for something off-speed here. Nope, he goes high fastball, so he's going to change his eye level here.
That's why I'm up in the booth. I was expecting curveball.
Well, there's a couple ways you can play there. You go high with the fastball, now you come low. You change the eye level. The players know that. I mean, Jake's been catching since he could crawl, so he knows. And there's the pitch, and there it is in the dirt, right? And it gets away. Here comes Clay from third base, and he scores, and Hizak moves up to third.
Good hustle.
You know, excellent hustle. How to read that? Sorry, Paul.
Catcher's in a tough position here. That ball bounces that close to around home plate. It puts him in a tough spot. Yeah. When it bounces over you afterwards.
That was almost like 2 feet in front of the plate. You got to trust your catcher there, but, I mean, you got to give him a better chance than that. Full count now.
Runners move 90. We score one. That's a crooked number.
Actually, is it 2-2, Paul, or is it full? I think it's 2-2.
2-2.
And Jake fouls one back. Jake just needs to put the ball on the plate to the right. That'll score another run. There comes the pitch. Fastball up high, and it's full.
We have one down. You have Matt Woodward on deck. Matt also has been hitting the ball extremely well. So we're in a good position. Just don't chase here.
There's the pitch. Fastball just outside. Ball four, and we have a walk, and we have first and third.
Now batting number 21, Matt Woodward.
Matty, another one of those kids we've been around since he's been seven. He had a great outing last game. 10 strikeouts. He just dominated from the bump. It was as flawless as you can get.
2 hits, 1 walk, 10 strikeouts. Doesn't get much better than that. Olmstead comes out, called to his infield again. Jake digging in over at first base. And he takes off. Fastball right down the middle. A throw down to second base is good. And he's got him. And he's out. And Hizak stays at third base.
Hizak stayed at third.
Didn't read it very well. I mean, that's a beautiful throw right on the money. Those are the kind of shortstops love. Knee high. All you got to do is drop the glove. And we have one strike on Matt now with 2 outs.
So like we said, you know, Olmstead's a good defensive catcher. Good throw.
High fastball, ball one, 1-1 count. Well, he got a great pitch to throw him out on.
He did.
It looked like
right
Matt
there.
Had to take a fastball right down the middle. Hey,
Matty. Puts the catcher in a good position.
Sure does. Let's go, Matty rocks, watches ball two. 2-1 count.
Again, no changes. They're playing him straight away.
Yep. DeMoss rubs the ball up a little bit. Peers in for the sign. Likes what he sees. There's the stretch and the pitch. High fastball. Matt's going to lay off of that. Counts now 2-2.
He saw that thinking he was just going to drive that. But you're right. When you get that two ball, one strike count.
He's looking fastball. Mm-hmm. He got it. Just a little bit high. There comes the pitch. Fastball fouled. Looks like it's going to go out of play.
Just behind the backstop.
Count stays 2-2. I mean, it doesn't get any easier. You got Nick Labrie looming in the on-deck circle.
And I'll tell you what, you lay a fastball down the middle, Nick's going to make them pay, so And Matt's got some speed if he can get on, put your runners in second and third.
Pitch, curveball in the dirt. Nice stop back there. There you go. We have to trust your catcher with the runner on third base. Tomas licks his fingers a little bit, looking for a better grip on that ball. Full count now. Probably going to come with the fastball. That's what Maddie's thinking. There it is. Fastball. Popped him up. Coming over this way. Out of play.
It's out behind Dad's Row.
Sure is.
Right behind home plate. That's where the Goffstown dads have been standing for as long as I've come down here.
That's my spot. It's usually where I am if I'm not up in the booth. Another payoff pitch coming here. Gets the sign, stretch, throw, in the dirt, blocked, runner coming. Oh, he's got him hung up now. Isaac's got him hung up. Third baseman's coming, running him down. Too many throws, pitcher's got to run him back. Runs him back, doesn't make
That's
a throw,
right.
And he's safe.
Throw. And Matt,
and Matt
is on
takes second
base.
Base. Great job by Isaac. I mean, the catcher did a good job.
Number 20, Nick
LaGreen. Catcher did a good job. He did what he needed to do. He needed to run him back a little bit further. And then, you know, once you get into three, four throws, that's never a good thing for the defense. And that was the pitcher, DeMas, who was down there and just either couldn't get the ball out or just didn't make the throw. And here's LaBrie. Inning continues for Goffstown. Fastball, and there it is.
There it is.
There's a long drive, hit the left field. Left fielder going back, camped under it, and he does not make the catch. It goes over his head. Two runs will score. LaBrie's heading into second base, and he's in there standing with a two-run double.
Now batting number 13, Peter Hunt.
You know, but again, Mike, the outfielders are taking a step in. That was an easy – it was a pop fly.
He definitely should have had – he definitely misplayed it. I mean, he goes from the sun to the shade out there, and the ball just – you just, like, look, he lost it, and the ball landed over his head.
And Nick made him pay. He's now on second, scored two runs.
And it's now 4-0 Goffstown, and you got Peter Hunt at the plate. Fastball, high strike. Beats the eighth batter to bat this inning. It doesn't get any easier with Carter Swinard on deck. Be thought about it, laid off. Good take right there.
You know, I'll tell you what about Pete. Pete can play first base, plays outfield. They have him playing everywhere.
Here comes the pitch, high fastball. Kind of hard to throw it over Pete's head. Pete stands 6'3". Tallest of the Grizzlies, senior. Comes the pitch, that's low. 3-1.
Tell you, the two errors have forced him to throw a lot of pitches so far.
Sure has. DeMas should have been out of this inning a while ago. Here comes the pitch. There's a fastball popped up. First base way, DeMas is going to take it himself, and he does. And that'll end the inning. But Goffstown puts up a four spot, and the score after one full is 4-0 Goffstown.
After the first inning, Bobcats 0, Grizzlies 4.
Pitches, Mike. That's an awful lot of pitches for your first inning. Those errors, two errors, did not do him any justice. Eight batters on there, so leading off, we'll have Carter Schmidt when we start off in the second.
And he's got great speed, too.
Get him on. He's that threat.
So now I think you'll see Hizak settle down here. The butterflies are probably gone. He got up once. He's got a four-run cushion out there right now.
Changes the way you pitch when you have that lead this early.
Sure does. I mean, trust your defense. I mean, you get the six-hitter coming up, right?
We do.
And
you have 6, 7, and 8 coming up.
Yep. Trust your defense. Let them do what they do. And just trust your fastball. I mean, again, as I said, it's a four-run lead, so what you don't want to do is start walking the ballpark and put runners on base.
You don't want to overthrow. You have a great defense out there. The outfield can fly. They have great arms. Infield is as good as there is anybody in any division in the state.
Jake calls for a throwdown. Balls are coming in. Fastball, throw down, good throw.
Nice shoot there.
Now batting number four, Nick Quayle.
Nick Quayle is the first baseman, a lefty. Meeting at the mound. Jake, I'm sure, is just telling him, hey, you know, you got a lead, just throw strikes here.
Absolutely. No need to strike everybody out.
Just throw strikes and have them put the ball in play.
Absolutely.
Like I said, trust your defense. Playing straight away again. Here comes the pitch. Fastball. Misses outside. Kicks, throws, foul out of play. About 10 feet more to the left, and that's right in our window.
Yes, it is. That's why I need to pay attention.
Quayle's back is about as far as you can get in that batter's box. Fastball low, foul down the third baseline.
A little late in that swing again.
1-2. He's seen him three fastballs so far. So as a hitter, you got to think you're going to see that hook, but you don't know. Ball being retrieved. I'd be looking for the hook right here, but let's see. He's been late.
He's
on
got
the
one
fastball.
To waste.
Fastball, little ground ball, right back to Hizak. Bobbles it, got plenty of time, picks it up. Oh, almost threw it away, and he did. And the runner is safe at first base. Well, see, there's a good lesson for you right there. Good job by Quayle. You got to run those out.
Batting number 12, Ben Olmstead.
Exactly right, Mike. And if you don't run it out, then all you did was hurt yourself and hurt your team. Now he's 90 feet down, and he's putting himself in a position if they can get some hits here.
And Hizak just put some more added pressure on himself. A little ground ball. He botched it a little bit. Still had plenty of time to make that throw. Took Labrie off the bag. Now let's see how they do.
This is Ben Olmstead, the catcher.
High fastball for ball one. And let's hope that doesn't affect Hizak, because that's where he was in the first inning, up high, and he's been pretty good this inning so far. Very short lead over there. Labrie holding him on. Steps off, makes an easy throw over. No problem getting back.
Not much change defensively. Everybody's straight away. Smitty's a shade over towards second. Like you said, a very short lead.
Quick throw over.
Almost caught him in that half step.
Yep, he sure did. I'm sure Connor's a little upset with himself on that play. Wants to get it all back here. You want to make a mistake with Olmstead, though. Again, high fastball. Connor's overthrowing right now.
Exactly right. And I think that we talked about earlier, he's upset with himself. So I hope right now he just has to learn. It's a learning moment right here.
Mm-hmm.
Calm down, breathe, and he's going to do fine. He's a great athlete.
And again, high. Wouldn't be surprised to see Jake go out there if he walks him. Yep. Time called at the plate. Batter doing some equipment repairs, tying his cleat. 3-0. Time is out. The runner goes back to the bag. And we're all set. 3-0. Good hitter here. You might see him swing away if he gets a nice juicy fastball down the middle. Here comes the pitch. And it's right down the middle, and he's taken all the way.
That's the spot he needs to hit right there, Mike.
Yep.
He gets back to throwing his fastball right there. He took a little bit off, as you can see. He's not overthrown, but that was a nice pitch. He looked comfortable throwing it.
And that's all he needs to do right now. Pitch again inside. Ball four, and we now have first and second with no outs.
Now batting number 9, Dan Carey.
Carey's the left fielder. He's got the hooded sweatshirt on, but his is a short sleeve.
Short sleeve, it looks like.
Or he has it pulled up. That could be a Belichick sweatshirt.
It could be.
Arms cut off.
He's wearing number 9. Famous Red Sox, Ted Williams, number 9. Happened to be my favorite player.
First and second, no outs here. Fastball, and there's a shot up the middle. There's a base hit. Runner was going back. And Chouinard with a quick throw into third base, and Cody could not make the scoop. And runners are safe everywhere. Almost turned into a fielder's choice. Line drive, the runner had to go back. Clay Campbell made a great diving effort at it, and then heads up by Chouinard to pick that ball up and throw it in. Cody just could not scoop it up. So now we have bases loaded, no outs.
I'll tell you what, it was a good baseball play thinking, hey, I'll just shoot him at third base.
Yeah.
You know, I get what you're saying, that he was held up here at second base. But this is going to be the test here. Is he going to get himself out of this?
Nine hitter Coster. He's the center fielder. He's digging in. Wiggles his bat. Fastball hits the bat, and that's a strike. Oh, actually, they're saying it hit him. They're saying it hit him, and that forces in a run. It's now 4-1, and Lawrence is going out to calm his young freshman down. It must have hit the top of his helmet.
I think it hit the top of his helmet, Mike.
I thought it hit the bat.
He didn't move. So
right, exactly, which way I thought it hit the bat because he didn't move. But
I don't know if he lost it himself.
It must have grazed the top of his helmet. Hey, if you're going to get hit, that's the way you want to get hit, especially when it's in the dome.
Just barely grazed, right? Barely catching you.
So we got conversation happening at the mound. 4-1 Goffstown. Bases loaded, no outs, and good job by Lawrence there, calming his young pitcher down.
Now batting number 3, Mike Hogan.
We roll to the top of the order. Hogan was hit by a pitch on a full count his first at bat. Hizak just needs to keep the ball down. Trust your defense. Got to get an out here. Labrie playing behind the runner at first. All the runners were pretty decent leads right now. Hogan is looking to put the ball in play. Here comes the pitch. Fastball low in the dirt. Ball one.
I just wonder what kind of a secondary lead first and second are going to take. And obviously, third's not going to take off because Jake can shoot him down. But the other two could take that secondary lead.
Yeah, they're moving pretty good. Popped him up. Labrie going over towards the fence. He's going to run out of room, and that's fouled away. Counts 1-1. Labrie had a beat on it, just ran out of real estate. Puts the hat on to cover those long flowing locks that he has.
Guess it's part of the in thing with some of these players, though. The long hair in the back.
1-1, let's see what Hizak goes to here. Fastball just kind of reached out, fouls it off. Now he's got a 1-2 count.
What is it, oh. Randy Johnson? I hit a car over there.
I hit a car. Not sure whose. Wasn't mine.
No, it might have been Pinard's new truck. Justin Pinard's father's brand new truck maybe got hit.
1-2, see what he does. Runners have good second, and he throws it in the dirt. That's not an – oh, the runner on first thought so. You can't advance on that with the bases occupied. Nice stop by Jake.
Now batting number 8, Owen Brickley.
Threw him the curveball. Big out right there.
That was huge.
Brickley was also hit by a pitch his first at bat.
Again with that full count.
Fastball, and that's a line drive to center field. That's going to fall. That's in the gap. Cut off by Schwenard. Two runners are coming around. A second coming. Labrie makes the cut. Doesn't throw home, and it's two runs scored. A base hit by Brickley, and just like that, it's 4-3.
Now batting number 7, Dylan Donahue.
It was a solid hit to center field.
Sure was. First pitch fastball.
That's what you expect of your second hitter. Right now you have Dylan Donahue's coming up.
Flied out to center his last time up. Now we get first and second. One out. Pitch fastball in there for a strike. He's throwing a lot of fastballs. He only thrown the one curveball. Got the strikeout of Hogan on the curveball, but the Bobcats are seeing this, and they're adjusting to the fastball. Donahue way up in front of the plate, expecting the curveball. There it is. That's hitting the hole. Picked up by Campbell. Campbell goes to second for one. Can't make the turn.
Can't make the turn.
So we end up with first and third, but two outs. It's a good play. Get the out. Get the shore out at second base.
Now batter number 11, Garrett DeMoss.
And now you get the pitcher, DeMoss, up, looking for a little payback here.
Who struck out last time he was up in first inning.
Struck out, but he's the pitcher. He had a tough inning. He can tie the ball game here with a base hit. He's looking down the third for a sign. Donahue looks like he's ready to take off. Let's see how they play this. He's got a big lead over there. Gets even bigger on his secondary lead. Pitch in the dirt. Ball one. Good stop by Jake. Donahue with a good lead over there. Looks like he's getting ready to take off. He was kind of leaning a little.
He did. He took that little extra step.
Yep. Hizak saw it. Good pitch to run on. It's a 1-0 pitch. You're probably going to get a fastball. Jake's going to look for some. He throw a quick throw over. He's back safely again. First base coach was all over that. I heard him yell back from here. Jake's got to think what he wants to do here. Fastball. There it is. Whoa, that's going to take out a car. Oh, hit one and went under another one. That's the price you pay for good seats and having fans close to the field.
Absolutely.
The parking lot's right there. Got a 1-1 count here. Does he go to the off-speed pitch? He doesn't. He throws a fastball low. Seems to be tying Jake up a little bit back there. Jake's boxed a few of those.
He's getting the balls are down into his right. So, you know, now he's just missing that way. Maybe he's overcorrecting.
Steps off, throws over to first base. LeBrie does a good job of checking that runner at third. Can't lose sight of that guy at third base. 2-1 count here. Good hitters count. Here comes the pitch. Fastball up high. Now it's 3-1. This is the pitcher, DeMoss, number 4 hitter. 3-1, great pitch to run on. Going to get a fastball here. He does. He swings and fouls it off. Great pitch to hit.
It was. He'd like that one back.
Yeah, he sure would. Just looking up. Count is full now, so you know the runner at first is going to take off. Wouldn't be surprised to see Hizak kick a throw over there. He doesn't. Runner goes. There's the pitch. Fastball fouled away. Runner at third was charging, too.
He was.
Now, I don't know. There you walk. Jake puts the tag on him. I don't understand that one. Their base coach just leaned out to him and said, I don't think you're fourth there, buddy.
He doesn't want to do that.
He shouldn't be running. Two outs. He walks. Here we go again. Full count. And here's the throw over, as I mentioned on the last pitch. Runner leaning. You might as well give it a shot. This curveball was on. I would say he'd throw it here, but going to look for a fastball. There it comes. There it is. And there's a line shot down the left field line. That's a fair ball. And that's going into the corner. Runner from first is going to be held up at third base. It's a double for DeMoss, and it's a tie ball game.
Just like that, how things change.
Well, that's what happens, Paul, when you can just throw your fastball. Sorry, I'll let Nate do his job.
Now batting number 14, Patrick Malm.
Nice job, Nate. We got second and third now.
Patrick struck out last time he was up.
Yep, but Malm's got a chance now to put Plymouth in the lead. Fastball, swing and fouled into Jake's mitt. Strike one. Hizak definitely had a little extra gas on that one.
Just don't want to see him overthrow with a wild pitch right here. Like to see him just stay in control.
Pitch low in the dirt. And he almost did it there. Nice job, nice block by Jake.
We have two down. This would be a great time for him to get out. Regroup.
Malm was way late last time. Fastball, and he hits a fly ball to left field. Hunt coming in. He's under it and makes the grab to retire the side. But Plymouth does get four to tie the game.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mike. I know it was a tough inning. He threw 28 pitches there. That's 53 pitches so far in two innings. Warm day, pitches day. Maybe, like we said, maybe he's a little nervous last time he was out. It was cold. It was away. Home brings that different vibe.
Sure do, but, you know, you get a team. You have the team on the ropes. That's when you got to come in and have a shutdown inning. And, you know, it wasn't like he wasn't all over there. He was throwing strikes, and they were hitting him. They hit him hard that inning.
They did. Absolutely did.
And, you know, it'll be interesting to see how the freshman bounces back. I mean, he's been dominating. As you said, he's been dominating. He dominated in middle school last year. He dominated essentially his whole career in Little League, and he's not used to getting lit up like that.
Well, this is the maturity test, right? They say, welcome to the, you know,
welcome
varsity,
to the big leagues. Right? That's it.
This is, you know, Goffstown baseball. There's a lot of pressure. Great teams. I think, the past 4 years, been in the Final Four. State championship have gone twice. Won one, lost one. So, you know, and he knows what's expected. And he's hotter on himself than anybody else right now. He'll settle down. He'll come in here. When he comes up to bat in this inning, most likely, because we're going to have Connor Schwinnard, Ethan Smith, and Clay Campbell.
Yep.
Coming up 9-1-2, and you know if Connor gets up there, he's going to help himself. There's no doubt in my mind.
I mean, you got this Plymouth team scored 22 runs in their three games, scored 7 in the first game. They lost 10-7. Then they shut out Sanborn Regional 9-0, and then they shut out they beat Kingswood 6-5 in a barn burner. So they can score some runs.
They can hit, right? And we knew that coming in. Now we have Carter Schwinnard. He's a junior for Gostown, but again, he's been around for a long time, lives up there in the spice rack, like
sure
a lot
does.
Of these ball players do.
Couple, at least three anyway. There's a pitch in the dirt. Olmstead, that's going to go back to the backstop. He'll grab one from the ump and shoot it down.
Carter still loves Jacoby Ellsbury, even with taking off. Chasing
now
the money.
Batting number 2, Carter Schwinnard.
Well, he likes Ellsbury because he runs like him. Plays
absolutely.
His position.
Boy,
and even wears the same number.
Carter Schwinnard is as fast as they come right there.
And a
rocket for an arm,
oh,
too.
Yeah. In Little League, his nickname was Wheels. Not sure if that's still his nickname or not. First pitch, fastball, ground ball right back to DeMoss. Spares it, throws to first, and one out just like that. That's the way our inning could have started last day. Remember, it was Hyzak on that ground ball that
right.
started that whole inning.
Now batting number 10, Ethan Smith.
Ethan hit a ground ball in the hole short, is hustled on the line, forced a bad throw, ended up on second base. Ethan doesn't hang around. If he gets a first pitch fastball, he usually swings. There it is, and he swings, and he hits a lazy fly ball to the right field. The right fielder coming in, and he makes the grab. And two pitches, two outs, just like that. So by rule, you have to take this pitch. You don't get a three-pitch inning.
Now batting number 14, Clay Campbell.
So, Paul, like I was mentioning, a shutdown inning. So you come out, score 4 runs, and now DeMoss comes out, throws 2 pitches, and he's already got 2 outs.
Right.
Campbell has to take here.
Oh, absolutely.
Pitch up high, ball. That was a pretty easy pitch to take. Got to let him throw a few. How many did you say DeMoss threw in the first inning?
35.
35, and he's got 3 this inning. Quite a difference. Fastball, just missed, 2-0.
But you know, again, Clay's been around the ball field quite a bit. He knows right now. Make this kid throw a little bit, slow things down.
Right. I mean, there's no problem taking a strike here. Pitch in the dirt, 3-0. Now you're making him throw a strike. And DeMoss, who was right on with those first two pitches, first two fastballs right down the middle, two pitches, 2 outs, has now fallen behind 3-0 to Campbell. Deep breath, looks in for the sign, step back, kicks and throws, and there's a strike right down the middle. Taken all the way, good second hitter.
That's Campbell's just what you want. See the pitches, right?
Yep. Campbell singled the right his last time up. Just got to protect that dish right here. Catcher setting up outside, is the pitch, fastball, and it's foul straight back.
You know, that was a nice cut.
Sure was.
The ball comes back like that, you know, you
right
didn't
on
miss
it.
By much.
Hope he didn't hit our GoPro back there.
No, it's still looking pretty good.
Deep breath from DeMoss on the mound. Looks in for the sign, kicks and throws. Fastball, and there's a lazy fly ball to center. Center field is playing deep. He's coming in hard and makes the grab to retire the side. The Goffstown goes out 1-2-3 in the bottom of the second inning. Score after 2. Goffstown 4, Plymouth 4.
Only 9 pitches. That inning.
That's a heck of an inning after throwing 35.
Boy.
So now he's thrown less pitches in 2 innings than Hyzak has, right?
Yes.
So
after 2 innings, all mounted up at 4.
We didn't do ourselves any favors. You know, I know everyone's down a little antsy. They know it's 4-4. Some people are going to try to do too much too soon. It's not uncommon.
Yeah, I mean, you had Schwinnard coming up there. But, hey, it's kind of hard. You get a first pitch fastball right in your wheelhouse, you know, you take a shot at it. And Carter hit the ball hard. I mean, he hit a one hopper right back to the pitcher. He doesn't spare that. That goes into center
that
field.
That goes into center, right.
And Smitty, again, just as I said it, you know, he doesn't hang around a lot.
No, he doesn't.
He gets a first pitch, and he swung, and he did, and hit a lazy fly ball to right. And then Campbell put a good 6-pitch at bat on. But in the end, DeMoss won the battle. So it looks like we have 5, 6, 7 coming up. Malm, Qualley, and Olmstead. They did some damage.
They hit the ball well. A lot of hits to center field. They were right on it. They knew that when Connor took a little bit off that fastball, that was sitting fastball, and they did what they're supposed to do with it. That ball comes in, and they drove it.
And that's what happens when you get yourself into a situation where you have to rely on your fastball. I mean, these are high school varsity players. They can hit fastballs. And, you know, like I said, Isaac's used to overpowering teams, but, you know, as a freshman, he's going up against juniors and seniors, and they can hit the ball.
Kids can hit now.
They sure can, especially the fastball. Jake lollipops one down a short. Home plate umpire brushing the dish off.
And last time Nick was up, we had that error to first from Connor. And again,
now batting number four, Nick Qualley.
It's just got to be those nerves. Maybe after yesterday's Red Sox, Bruins, Celtics.
So Nick hit the ground ball back to the pitcher. First pitch, fastball in there for a strike.
There you go. Get ahead, stay ahead. And that's what we want right now.
And that's what started it all off. Remember, there was nobody on, nobody out on that ground ball. And it was not hit very hard. Pitch, swing and a miss. And he made him look bad on that one.
Put a little bit extra on that one.
Sure did.
But, you know, his release point was where it should be. Nice follow through.
Jake with a low target. And there's the curveball. Nice pitch. No. Must have been a little outside. That ball did hook. Probably came around the plate. Hard to tell from our vantage point.
We'll check the GoPro when this thing's aired.
Fastball. Foul back. Count remains 1-2. Well, the umpire's got a much better vantage point than we do.
He does.
They're doing a great job so far. The men in blue. There's the kick and the pitch. Fastball, low and inside, 2-2. Being a former umpire myself, I don't pick on the umpires much.
You can sympathize with them.
Here's a fastball fouled away, way late on that one. Count remains 2-2. Nice stab by the third base coach. Hopefully the GoPro picked that one up. Isaac kicks and delivers low. Full count. Here's the payoff pitch.
That's it.
Connor, strike three. Great pitch right there.
10-pitch at bat right there, Mike.
Now batting number 12, Ben Olmstead.
Here's the catcher, Olmstead. What did Ben do his first time up?
He walked.
And there's a pitch, ball one. Standing up straight. Now he gets ready, takes a strike. Good pitch there. Inside, would have jammed him if he swung. Way late on a fastball. 1-2. Isaac's working at a very quick pace right now.
Well, if that's what he needs to do, if he needs to get that tempo going and that's working for him, keep it up.
Fastball right down the middle, strike three. He's not fooling around right now. You know, an Olmstead as a catcher, he needs to step out right there and slow him down.
Absolutely. You don't watch that.
Batting number 9, Dan Carey.
So this could be just what the doctor ordered here if Isaac comes right back and gets his own 1-2-3 inning. Pitch low in the dirt, ball one. He's thrown a few more pitches than DeMoss has, but
he has.
As long as we get the same result.
Dan Carey here, he went to center field on a fly ball last time.
Very bad swing. Looked like it was fooled, but that was just a straight fastball.
It did. That was just straight fastball. That wasn't a curveball or anything.
Nice pitch. Slow roll or foul. Cody will come down and gobble that up. Gets the ball back in. 1-2 is the count. Nothing slowing Hizak down here. Moose is still walking back to his spot, and he gets into his windup. It is a curveball in the dirt. Gets by Jake. Jake's running after it, and the runner's going to reach. On a third strike in the dirt, the runner reaches on a wild pitch strikeout.
Now batting number 2, Devlin Costa.
and the inning continues.
Devin was hit by a pitch last time.
Yeah, he's the one who took it off the head.
Just grazed his helmet, didn't it?
Yeah, first pitch was a fastball up high. I thought it hit the bat. Let's hope this doesn't lead to something here. Fastball right down the middle. Vicious swing by Costa. He looked like he was trying to hit that one back to Plymouth. Pitch, curveball in the dirt. Nice stop by Jake. That one hit skin. Well, those aren't fun.
No, that's not fun. That's going to leave a mark. But you know what? If Costa thinks he's going to stay, you know, challenge, you know, meet that challenge, that fastball, he'll be late.
There's the fastball, and he fouls it back.
Like the way he's throwing right now, there's a much different Connor Hyzak this third inning than there was the first two. His tempo is different. He seems to be now pitching with a man on a mission almost.
Yeah, he's working very quickly. Fastball up high, 2-2. He's working like someone's chasing him right now.
Well, we need to get out of this right here.
2-2, don't mess around. There it is, fastball up high, full count. And the runner will be off with the pitch. You'll see Carey taking off with the pitch. Hyzak might throw over. He did it last inning. Throw over to keep him close. Not much of a lead over there, though. And there he goes. Runner takes off. Fastball misses low. And now we have first and second with two outs.
Now batting number three, Mike Hogan.
And now we roll the top of the order. Hogan's third at bat already.
Hit by pitch and a K so far.
All it takes is a looper here, a little punch and Judy. No one's holding on the runner at second base either, and he's got a tiny lead. Now he's starting to etch out a little bit. No one even looking at him. Swing late and a foul ball. On a hop goes between a couple cars. I can't believe no one's even looking at him.
Well, that's what I'm thinking. I don't want to see Campbell get so out of position, but he's got to be able to come over and come back.
Yeah, he's there, but I might, wow.
Nice pitch.
Fooled
right
him
there.
On that pitch. Wow. He was way ahead of that. He's late on the first one. It looked like a changeup. He was way ahead of that pitch. Now he doesn't know what he's going to throw. I throw him a fastball here. He does, and the dirt hits the plate.
Hit the plate.
He goes to the backstop, and the runners will move up 90 feet.
Nothing you can do on that one.
Nope. He overthrew that. He was trying to throw it through the backstop. That just hit the edge of the plate. And now we have second and third with two outs. Now he does that again. That scores a run. So what looked like an easy inning, now he's got to bear down and work hard. His pace is a little slower now. Stretch is the pitch. Fastball, ground ball, back to Hyzak. Makes a nice scoop and throws over to Labrie to end the inning. Well, Plymouth threatens but does not score. And the score at the end of 3.5, 4-4.
It was 26 pitches.
So he has not had an easy inning yet.
No, he hasn't. We're at 54 after three innings.
No, he was 54 after two, right?
Oh, you're right. That's that Commonwealth. That's that Commonwealth Mass.
Math. So how many did you throw that inning?
So we had 26.
26.
28.
78 pitches.
78
so
pitches.
Far. Wow, in three innings. I mean, I know he's a young kid, but there's a pitch count this year in varsity baseball. It's not by innings anymore. It's by pitches. And you can only throw so many in a week. And with three games this week on a Monday, don't know. And they got four next week.
Next week is the bigger week.
Just found out today that the game that got rained out on Friday against Windham has been rescheduled to next Thursday, the 4th.
I'd like to know who scheduled that game, makeup game. Why would you do that to Goffstown?
It wasn't me, Paul. Well, you don't know what Wyndham's schedule is next week. Maybe somebody can look up Wyndham's schedule and see if we can see what they're doing next week. But Goffstown slated to have three this week. Wednesday, we get a nice spring/summer day in New Hampshire today. And tomorrow it's going to be late fall again, where it's going to be 45 degrees and raining. And Wednesday, a mix of fall and spring. It'll be about 50 degrees overcast. So just wait a minute. You don't like the New England weather, just wait. It'll change.
Absolutely. Up and down like a three-year-old on a sugar high.
So let's see. Wyndham's got Lebanon today. They're playing at home versus Lebanon today. And then on Wednesday, they got Sauhegan. And Friday, they got Pembroke. And they also have four games next week, though, Paul. They got Milford, Conval, and Milford again. So they play Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday as well.
The NHIAA was not happy or not good to either one of those teams right now.
Now batting number five, Connor Hyzak.
Well, the other problem is you don't have many days to make up these games.
Yeah. Playoffs start in June, right?
It's got to be done before school's out. So Hyzak, slow curve for a ball. Boy, that looked like a Bill Lee lollipop curve back from the 70s. I think I'm dating myself on that one.
You are. That's why we love you. Connor smashed the ball in the first inning.
Yeah,
deep center field.
Over to center field. And the center fielder was playing in a different zip code right now, and Hyzak way ahead of that pitch.
He's got a nice spot there in right center field. Right field is playing pretty shallow.
Yeah.
And the center field is deep into the left. The
center field is playing in where right now? I need binoculars to see him.
Let's go, kid. What do you say? Drive it. Grip the rip.
Hyzak way up on the plate. Slow curve way ahead of it. Strike two.
That was a heck of a pitch right there.
He's throwing three off-speed pitches to him. Two slow curves, and it looked like a changeup on that second pitch that Hyzak was way ahead of. So you got to learn from that now. Now as a freshman, you know, you got to learn from that. He actually steps back in the box, probably thinking maybe he's going to come with a fastball. And he does, and he hits a ground ball by third base, foul. Count remains at 1-2. So Hyzak actually read that one right. He moved a little back in the box, and the Mice come in with the fastball. You have to throw him three slow curves. Well, two slow curves and a changeup. Something you don't see very often. He's actually standing in the hole in front of the rubber. You don't see many pitchers do that. They usually stand on the rubber and then put their foot in it. Slow curve hits him. We'll take that.
I'll tell you what, Mike. If you notice the pitcher, when he went to throw that time, he changed his whole momentum coming home. So he telegraphed that.
Sure did. If you're going to get hit, that's the pitch you want to get hit by. Sorry,
Nate. Batting number eight, Cody Morale.
It's Cody. I'm sure he wants to make up for his last at-bat.
He did. He didn't like that last call, and he's a smart hitter. And no one's, he's too tough on himself, so he'll be – he's ready
Hyzak,
for
a giant lead throw over there.
Again, they're giving Cody that right center field.
Sure are. Right field line, too. The right field is about 50 feet off the line. He's actually moving more towards right center. That could be a mistake. The pitcher's going to go off speed. Cody's going to pull it. And the outfield is actually shifted over towards, leaning towards right left field. Not sure why. Left fielder is almost down the line. He's closer to the line than the right fielder is. Hyzak looks like he's going to run. He fakes it, and there's a ball low. Olmstead with a great arm back there. We saw that already.
Cody will do the right thing. He knows he's going to. Wait for that pitch that he wants right here. He's in that position. Man on first, no outs.
But, Paul, look at that hole between first and second. First baseman holding the runner on. Second baseman's 20 feet from the bag. I mean, he hits it right there, but he hits it to the second baseman who throws to second. That's not going to be in time. He's safe.
He's safe.
Great hustle by Connor to get to the bag.
Now batting number 18, Jake Hunt.
Get that fielder's choice, the error. You know, when shortstop receiving that, he should have had that.
He should have had it. You know, the second baseman kind of hung him out to dry with that little touch.
He did.
You got to turn and throw it. You got to give him a little bit. But Hyzak bearing down on him, it's really hard to blame the shortstop.
He heard the footsteps.
He sure did.
Connor's a quick kid.
And he's a big kid. Hunt takes a strike right down the middle. Jake would also like to do something here. First and second. What did Jake do his first time up? He walked. Still get that same hole between first and second. Even more so now. High fastball, ball one. 1-1 count. So the second baseman is kind of moving over to hold on and gives almost a 80-foot hole over there between the first and second base bags. Look at this.
And center fielder is staying deep.
Oh, I think the ball stuck to his hand on the delivery. And both runners are going to try to move up, and they do.
Outstanding. It's smart baseball right there.
It sure is. But, I mean – DeMoss had a grip on the ball, and that ball hit the dirt probably 10 feet after it left his hand.
And again, catcher did a good job, you know, Olmstead for Plymouth to do what he could with that and at least try to get the ball down a third.
And Hyzak did a great job of reading that, and Cody as well. I mean, once Hyzak took off, Morell followed. Now Jake's got two runners in scoring position. Ball in play here will score a run easily. And there's a high fastball, and it's 3-1 now.
Well, he's got to come to him. This is the hitter's count right here, right?
Sure does.
3-1.
DeMoss looks a little discombobulated. He's tucking his shirt in. He's yanking at his arm. He should go for a walk around the mound.
Catch
get himself
maybe
together.
Talk to him.
Fastball. Jake swings at a high fastball.
That was ball four right there.
Yep, sure was. Now the count is. We tried to do a little bit too much.
Yep.
Jake is a senior, hasn't seen many pitches to hit. Looking to drive a pitch. Got a high fastball. Here we go, 3-2, fastball. Jake does a good job of fouling
just
that one off.
Fouled off.
That was a good pitch. Pitch was on the outside corner.
I think I don't know if he was thinking something different.
Well, that's a pitcher's pitch, Paul. That's knee-high outside corner. Not much you can do about that. I mean, Jake's got to be sitting fastball here. I don't know if DeMoss would go off speed. Fastball, and Jake fouls it off again. Right on that one.
Yep.
Hit that one the end of the bat. He was a little too quick.
Needs to take a deep breath right here.
Sure does. Takes a little walk around, practice swing. DeMoss breathing a little heavy out there on the mound. Doesn't get any easier with Matt Woodward on deck.
No, it doesn't at all.
Here comes the pitch. And there's a base. It's going to go, and it's caught. Oh. Nice grab by the first baseman. What a heck of a play right there. The first and second baseman both diving, and the first baseman comes up with it. Both runners have to stay.
Now batting number 21, Matt Woodward.
I thought for sure that was going to make the hole, Paul.
Just a defensive swing. Just wanted to throw the bat, you know, head of the bat out there, get it out to short right field.
All right, now it's up to Matt with one out. Runners on second and third. And Woodward fouls one off towards the cars. Let's see. No, it's going to go into the river.
Last time Matt worked that count up, we had eight pitches on his last at bat, and he walked. Did a really good job. Seen a lot of pitches, fouled a few off.
Yep. And there's a fastball hit foul. So it was quickly in the hole, 0-2. And you got Labrie on deck who hit that
just
high fly ball to left field that the left fielder misplayed. But it gave us two runs, so we'll take it. That made the score 4-0, and everything looked great at that point. Plymouth clawed their way back. Here's the 0-2 pitch, fastball outside. Olmstead did a good job of framing it, but the umpire wasn't buying it.
No, he wasn't.
No sale there. Olmstead leers in. See if he trusts that off-speed pitch. He threw those three slow curveballs. There's a fastball, and Woodward pounds it to left field. That's down the line. That's going all the way into the corner, all the way to the 340-foot sign. Two runners score, and Woodward's into second base.
He's going to third.
The ball gets loose. He's going to run this in. Here comes Woodward to third. Here's the throw. He's safe.
He's safe.
Great job by Woodward, taking advantage of a bad throw. And two runs score, and Woodward's at third base with one out.
Now batting number 20, Nick Labrie.
What a great read. He hits the ball, hits this ball right down the line. The ball rolled all the way to the 340 sign. The left fielder was way out there. The shortstop, I don't think, went out far enough.
No, he
didn't. The throw came in, it short hopped him and got by him. And it rolled probably 10 feet away, but Woodward just delayed going around second base and then just picked up and with his speed was in the third base easily.
That's baseball smart. You can't teach some of that stuff, and that's one thing right there.
You know, we hate to say it, but it's coaching growing up.
We can take some credit, right?
Probably half a dozen of us sitting here watching him right now with the rest down in Dad's row. There's a pitch to Labrie, takes strike one. Labrie jumped all over a fastball last time. I hit a fly ball to left that probably should have been caught, but we'll take it. Turned into a two-run. Well, how did we score that, a double or an error?
On which one?
We gave him an error, Labrie's.
Yeah, I gave that. That was just poorly played. It was a great hit, don't get me wrong.
Yep.
You know, but when you start to come in and where you were, the ball wound up, that's just.
Official scorer gives it an E. 1-1 count to Labrie. If he does that again, that'll score Woodward easily. And Labrie steps out, calls time. Feels like DeMoss has taken too much time on the rubber. So after having a 7-pitch inning last time, DeMoss is kind of struggling a little bit here. Fastball right down the middle, strike two. Labrie nods his head in agreement. It was a tough pitch. That's a pitcher's pitch right there. Peter Hunt on deck. There's this pitch outside, a little low. 2-2 count.
2-2.
Here comes the pitch. And it's a ground ball hit between. Oh, nice stop by the third baseman. He's going to let the run score. He throws over to first base, and he's got him. Nice scoop by the first baseman. The run does score, so there's two outs. But Labrie does his job, puts the ball in play. gets Woodward in from third base, and it's now 7-4 Goffstown.
Now batting number 13, Peter Hunt.
It's a very productive at-bat. That was a great play by the third baseman. Woodward delayed just a bit, then he took off. The third baseman gave him a look, but realized he didn't have a shot at him.
You know, that's just, again, with Matt's speed, he was off.
Slow curve for a strike. This is how we started the inning, with a couple of slow curves to Hyzak. And then he got away from it, started throwing his fastball. Let's see what he does here. Fastball outside. So it's good to see Goffstown respond after having Hyzak get out of that last inning.
They needed to, Mike.
Pitch in the dirt, 2-1.
And you know what? There's no reason that we couldn't. The second time, third time around for some, second time around for most, where they've seen this kid.
Yep.
So.
I mean, bottom of the third. Fastball, Hunt pops it up behind first base. First baseman almost runs into the umpire, chasing it, and it drops.
You know what? Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. And, you know, the umpire's part of the field, right?
Yeah.
He did his best to get out of the player's
right.
way.
He's in his position.
Right.
And, you know, first baseman had a beat on it. I think that little stutter step around the umpire probably cost him catching that ball. But, as you said, he's part of the field. Got to know where he is. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Fastball, strike three, swinging, and that'll retire the side. But Goffstown puts up three, and the score at the end of three innings, Goffstown 7, Plymouth 4.
After three innings, Plymouth 4, Goffstown 7.
That was our PA announcer, Nate, doing a great job. Looks like Mitchie Skarke coming out to start the fourth inning. Hyzak moving over to short. Campbell now moving to second base. Looks like Woodward's going to center.
It does. Yep, Matt.
Ethan Smith in left, and Peter Hunt is now going out to right field. So we're moving around a little bit here. Same nine. Carter Schwinnard is now out.
Carter Schwinnard is out. So
Mitchell is in Carter's spot. So we have Peter Hunt now in right, Matt Woodward now in center, and Ethan Smith now in left. So two of the three outfielders stay the same. Clay Campbell now at second, and Connor Hyzak moves from pitcher to short. Mitchell Skarke has been lights out so far this year. He's a little guy. He's 5'9", probably a 140 on him. He throws strikes. He's got a great fastball. He's got a great curveball. And he hides that ball well. You see him, he kind of ties himself up into a pretzel before he throws the ball. Hides the ball very well.
You know what's exceptional, too? He keeps the ball down.
Sure does.
He knows his role. He's been great at closing games. Keeps that ball low. He knows when to throw that curveball.
I know Mitch, he's been doing some traveling this weekend, too, going to look at some universities.
I'll tell you what, you're right, he's been down. He was down at Tufts University, Boston College, and a few others.
Brandeis, Babson, he's been all over the place.
One of the smartest kids in Goffstown.
Sure is.
For his class, and not just his class, in that school.
Now pitching for the Grizzlies, number 7, Mitch Skarke. And batting for Plymouth is number 8, Owen Brickley.
So second batter, second baseman, Brickley to lead off here. Brickley is 0-1. He was hit by a pitch and flew out to center field his second at bat. Mitch working from the windup. Peers in, gets the signal. Pitch, low fastball, just misses inside. Just a bit outside. 2-0 quickly here. Mitch works pretty quickly. Sees what he likes, throws, and there's a pop-up. Hyzak going back, camping underneath it, makes the call, and makes the grab, and there's one out. Nice job by Scott. He got it behind 2-0, came right in with the fastball and popped him up.
Now batting number 7, Dylan Donahue.
I tell you what, Mike, Dylan's gone to shortstop in center field. The kid can hit. Great power, like you said. He has a wide stance, but it works for him.
Pitch is in the dirt, and he gets him to swing. A little bit over-anxious there. Dylan trying to tie the game at one swing, and you can't do that when you're down 3. Need some base runners. Off-speed pitch, and he popped him up. Woodward moving over to his left and makes the grab in right center field for 2 down. Mitchell, 5 pitches, 2 outs. Told you he was a smart kid, Paul.
Now batting number 11, Garrett DeMoss.
And look at him out there. He's just poised.
Yeah, as calm as can be. You wouldn't know whether he's winning or losing right now by that expression.
And looking at mom and dad standing by the fence, I think they're more nervous than he is.
In the dirt, ball one. Mitchell's nickname, I Gotta Do It. Mom calls him Mitchy Moo. He's been calling him that forever. And he loves it. There's a late swing on a fastball. It's going to be fouled off. Oh, just missed my wife's car. And it's a 1-1 count. That van's been taking a beating lately. Doesn't need any more dents in it. Fastball. There's a line drive to left field. That's going to short hop Ethan Smith for a base hit. DeMoss keeps the inning going. 2-out single.
Now batting number 14, Patrick Malm.
That's Patrick Malm. Hasn't gotten any warmer as the game's gone on. He still has that hooded sweatshirt on.
It's worked for him. Well, except for the first at bat. He struck out the first one and the second time he flew to left field.
Inside with the fastball, ball one. 2 out, 7-4, Goffstown. Mitch was looking for 1-2-3 inning, but DeMoss said we'll have none of that. Short lead over at first base. Mitch looks at him and delivers, and there's a little pop-up. Mitch is going to handle it himself, and he does, and that'll retire the side. Excellent inning for Skaki. And the score at the end of 3.5, Goffstown 7 and Plymouth 4.
10 pitches for Mitchy on that. That's what you like. You come in here, you shut him right down. That was their 2, 3, and 4 hitters.
Yeah, big part of the batting order there. Coming off of 3 runs. And I mentioned earlier, you know, you got to have that shutdown inning once in a while. That's what you needed right there. Now you come up here, put another crooked number on, and this game can get away pretty quickly. Looks like DeMoss is coming back on the mound. Where is he at pitches, Paul?
We're at 73.
73 pitches for three innings. Where did Hizak end up with? He was probably in the 70s too, right?
He was 78.
78 pitches through 3. So we have Schwinnard's spot
right now
coming up.
We should have Mitchy should be where he took over for in the order for Carter. Should we have Mitchy?
Yep, and Mitchy's
Ethan
putting a helmet
Smith
on.
And Clay Campbell.
Mitchell's got a helmet on, so he's going to get out there. Mitchy's a lefty.
Now, what do you do? What are you thinking here? Mitch, as we know, knows how to lay that bunt on the third baseline.
Well, Mitch is going to get up there, and Mitch very rarely swings at the first pitch. So he's going to get up there, he's going to take a pitch, and he's going to survey this situation. So depending where the third baseman's playing him, if he's playing him on the grass, he probably won't see it. Mitch has better than average speed, not as fast as he was in Little League. The bases were a little shorter, but Mitch has good speed. You'll see him get in there. He'll probably take a strike.
He'll act like a leadoff hitter.
He batted leadoff most of his life. You know, you got Olmstead behind the dish, who's got a great arm. And then you got the top of the order coming up behind you. So, you know, you're just trying to get on right
here.
Be
smart.
You just want to be smart is right.
Now batting number 7, Mitch Scotchy.
If you listen closer, you might be able to hear his mother. Third baseman in on the grass. And there's Mitch taking a strike. Gee, it's almost like we've watched this kid play for a while.
Bunch of them, right?
Mitch takes that strike. Third baseman takes a step back now. Takes strike 2.
It's a nice pitch right there.
Yeah, it sure is. That's a pitcher's pitch. 0-1 pitch right on the outside corner. Third baseman, if I was him, I'd take another step back. 0-2, he's not going to bunt. 0-2 pitch is a slow curve, and he fouls it back. good waste of a pitch right there by Skocke.
And I agree, third baseman should give himself a little bit of real estate for that time. He's not going to bunt here with two strikes.
Although Mitch does have good speed, so it is a long throw.
He's coming up again.
There he comes, and he swings wildly at strike three. A little overmatched there. But Mitch is a pitcher, so he does what a pitcher does.
Now batting number 10, Ethan Smith.
There's Ethan now for the third time. He's reached an error and flat out to right field on the first pitch. He swung at the first pitch, both at bats.
He did.
So let's see if he does it again. Like I said, he doesn't hang around very often. There's the pitch, fastball up high, and he's carving away. He does not get cheated on his swings either, I'll tell you that. Pitch, slow curve in the dirt. You know, this is the part of the order he had the 1-2 training with a 9-1-2 coming up. So let's hope that this doesn't happen again.
Oh, exactly.
Although he's throwing a few more pitches this time. Fastball, Smitty pops it up. Shortstop calls the third baseman off, and makes the grab. Two up, two down so far for Goffstown. And we got Clay Campbell up, who's going to do his thing as a number three hitter, and the pitcher having a pretty easy inning so far.
Now batting number 14, Clay Campbell.
Clay digging in from the left side. DeMoss delivers, fastball, and Campbell swings, fouls it back.
He's worked both times at bat. He's worked that count right up. Taking a lot of pitches, looked at a lot, had some good cuts.
Base hit his first time up to right field and flew to center in his second at bat. 0-1 in the dirt. One-one, Hizak on deck. Sure, DeMoss wants to get this one. He doesn't want to deal with the meat of the order again. Slow curve, just missed.
That was a nice pitch.
It sure was. Although,
and Clay Olmstead held off.
Olmstead had to pick it up a little bit, but that's a good pitch. It's a tough pitch to lay off.
Looks like Clay's moved up a little in the box right there.
Here's a line drive up the middle.
Right,
that's going to reach Bates hit. Good hitting by Campbell. Two out base hit. See if we can get something going here.
Now batting number five, Connor Hizak.
See what Campbell does here. He's got some good speed. Good hit and run right here. I know there's two outs, but get some great speed on the bases. You got a good contact hitter here. Last time up, he saw three very slow off-speed pitches. High fastball, he gets a strike call. Honestly, I don't think he was looking fastball right there.
No.
After the first three pitches he got last time. DeMoss did a good job of keeping him off balance last time. Throws
taking
over to
that
first
lead.
Base. Campbell had a great lead. Looks like he might be going places. Good pitch to run on. You know, you might get an off-speed pitch here with an 0-1 count. Olmstead with a great arm behind the plate, but big lead by Campbell. Good second, and there's the slow off-speed pitch, just as I said. Would have been a good pitch to run on. It was low.
That was a good pitch to
Olmstead,
run on.
Looking back at the umpire, asking him where that pitch missed. Must have just missed a little low. Plymouth coach sitting there calling the pitches. Got a 1-1 count now. Fastball, and there's a ground ball to third. Fielded clean. He's going to go over to second base, force Campbell to retire the side. So Goffstown gets a hit, but does not score. And the score at the end of four innings, Goffstown 7 and Plymouth 4.
After four innings, Plymouth 4, Goffstown 7.
Good piece of hitting there by Hizak. A 1-1 count, got a fastball. A little ahead of it. Grounded it right to the third baseman on a one-hopper. Took the easy throw to get Campbell at second base.
I'll tell you what. We have Garrett's thrown 87 pitches so far for Plymouth. He looks wild every now and then. Does telegraph that curveball. You can see it. He slows down, but he's thrown a lot of pitches. I don't know if they're going to bring him back out next inning. I guess it'll dictate which way the score goes. And they have a busy schedule as well, like everybody else.
They sure do. Yeah, they got nobody warming up right now. But, you know, through four, he's thrown 87. Hizak threw 78 through three. So he's had those three long innings. He's had two very efficient innings.
And Plymouth has 6, 7, and 8 coming up. Nick Qualey, their first baseman. He grounded the first to the pitcher in the second inning, and he struck out looking in the third inning.
Both against Hizak. His first time facing Mitchie.
Now batting number 4, Nick Qualey.
Mitchie always has a smile on his face. Always happy to be here.
Sure does.
Never has an ill word to say about anybody. He's just one of those quality kids.
Tying his cleat right now before we get going. Umpire puts the ball in play, and here we go. First pitch, fastball, misses low. One ball, no strikes. Mitch takes the sign, kicks and throws. Fastball, strike.
Nice pitch right there. Again, keeping it low, right?
Yep.
Hit his spot a little bit outside.
Throws a lot of ground balls because he keeps the ball down. Here comes the 1-1 in the dirt. Jake scoops. Lewis lost the handle. Take a new ball. Mitch uncoils a fastball. 3-1. A little high on that one. Yeah. Qualey's got a good eye. Mitch is going to come in with it here. There's the 3-1. Fastball fired off, fouled it out behind us. Full count. There comes the payoff pitch to Qualey. Fastball, he hits it off the end of the bat. Campbell going out, not going to get there. Falls in between three Grizzlies.
Right in no man's land right there. Nothing he can do defensively right there, Mike. Right.
He couldn't have thrown the ball out there any better.
Now batting number 12, Ben Olmstead.
Campbell was the closest. I mean, the two outfielders are playing pretty far back. The ball wasn't hit that far, 120 feet. It was enough.
Just enough, right?
Here's the catcher, Olmstead.
Dying quail.
Olmstead has struck out looking and walked. He squares around a bunt, pitches high. Never pulled it back either. Well, he pulled it back at the end,
but he looked like
he was going to be he's definitely up there to bunt.
Looked like Jake wanted to throw down to first. The kid came off that bag quite a bit.
Yep, LeBrie's got to anchor to the bag. Jake's got a good arm. Good lead over there, squaring again. Morel's charging. Doesn't put the bunt down and takes a strike. So that leads me to believe that he's not really bunting. He's got a perfect pitch to bunt right there, and he
pulled
didn't
back.
Do it.
Didn't
so
do any, right?
I think he's just trying to get Cody in on the grass, and he is. And Cody's, he's squaring again, and he puts the bunt down. He puts it down foul. Cody grabs it with his foul, and now he's got a 1-2 count. Real surprised he didn't bunt that last pitch.
Thinking that to myself.
He would have went up the first baseline probably. It was an outside pitch. It was a good pitch.
And I'm just thinking, you see where Cody's playing at 30, played it perfectly, in position perfectly. Why not bunt up the first baseline?
Now Cody playing even with the bag with two strikes. Off-speed pitch, curveball, outside for a ball. Olmstead looked like he was bailing on that one, though.
You know, Mitchie has that, like we said, that low fastball, but he has some junk. He'll bend you.
Fastball.
Here we go.
Oh, strike
Here we
three.
Go.
Nice pitch.
Oh, there's a Mitchie
move. There's a Mitchie move. First one of the day right there.
Now batting number 9, Dan Carey.
Flew to center and struck out.
Didn't he? He reached the base on that
yes.
strikeout. He pops one up, right field, Hunt underneath it, makes the grab. Just like that, two down.
Now batting number 2, Devlin Costa.
Hit by pitch and walked.
Costa's been on base twice in the 9 hole. Looking to roll it to Mike Hogan here. Fastball swing, big cut. One strike. 7-4 Goffstown, top five. Wind's now blowing, not blowing much.
It's died down.
Gets a high strike there.
Well, I think, you know what, Mike? I think when Devlin went down, that brought his strike. You know, we think the strikes came down, but the ball was where, you know, right at that letter high. Still close, but if you notice, he squats down.
There's a line drive up the middle, caught by Hyzak to end the inning. So, retires the side, and we still are 7-4 Goffstown after five.
25 pitches after two innings. Mitchie's looking strong. When he comes back out, he'll be facing the top of the order. But right now, what we have coming up, we have Cody Morrell, Jake Hunt, and Matt Woodward. I know that Cody and Jake have been a little bit of a frustrating day, but like you know better than I do, pitches change. Any given at bat changes. Every pitch changes. So,
yep. Tomas Bach back out on the bump, 87 pitches deep into this outing.
You know, he's handled everybody pretty well, so I see no reason why you wouldn't bring him out
right
now. Short leash maybe, right? 7-4 game.
Yep.
Fifth inning.
So Morrell here is struck out looking and reached on the fielder's choice. Actually an error by the shortstop.
Shortstop.
Should have had that ball in that double play.
Well, Devlin looks a little bit more fatigued. I mean, understandably so, 80 degrees. When the day started, he's thrown 87 pitches. You know, he's worked.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt.
And, you know, he's already had three at-bats, so he's had a long day.
And he's the four hitter, so he'll probably be coming up next inning. Well, he'll be fourth hitter next inning.
They're going to keep the bat in the game, just put him somewhere in the field. But you're right, he digs that hole in the pitcher's mound, doesn't he? He's
dug
that pretty deep.
Sure does. His left foot looked like it slipped on its landing right there. Olmstead one hops at the second base.
Now batting number eight, Cody Morrell.
Cody Morrell, senior, and looks like he'll be going to play baseball at Plymouth State College after he graduates from Goffstown.
Might want to take a bus ride back with these boys and go watch the college play.
I know he and his dad were up there the other day. He said it was more like football weather than it was baseball, but they had a good time.
First pitch, fastball, foul straight back off the catcher.
You know, Cody looks a little frustrated right there, but that was a good cut, good swing.
Yeah, he's just a bit off. That's a pitch he crushes.
And he does.
He's just missing it right now. But he's a great hitter. Slow curve up high. Tell you what, that pitch is down a little bit, and that's going to be on the lacrosse field.
Yes, it is.
You're not going to fool Cody with that pitch. There comes the fastball. There it is, and Cody hits a line drive to center field, but right at the center fielder who leaps and makes the grab.
But again, Mike, did you notice how the outfielders for Plymouth are playing? The left field and right fielder are coming in first. It's already hurt them twice. That could have hurt them. There again, Cody could have had a nice stand-up double. He hit that very hard.
Batting number 18, Jake Hunt.
Cody, a little snake bitten on that one. He put a charge into that one. Center fielder moved over just a few steps and made the grab. He had a jump because he did make that step in. There's Jake. Jake swings at the first pitch and fouls it back. Time to get somebody on that kayak out there. It's at least four balls there today.
Save the taxpayers some money if they hired somebody out there.
Slow curve, ground ball right back to the mound. Throw to first, two down.
Now batting number 21, Matt Woodward.
Two down for Matt Woodward. Matt hit a double down the left field line, a rocket down the left field line.
Then he extended that to a triple with some sloppy play by Plymouth.
Slow curve in there for a strike.
He did the right thing. Why swing at that, right?
Yep. Damas is onto something here with these slow curves. He's got him 0-1. Why not throw it again? and he goes with a high fastball. So I don't know if that's a setup pitch or not, but if it is, you can count on the slow curve coming again.
He's at 96 pitches.
You get to 100, sell.
That's what I'm thinking.
There's the slow curve, and Matt thought about it and couldn't pull the trigger. That's a great pitch.
That was a nice pitch.
Pitch was there, and Matt just couldn't pull the trigger.
Still with a strong curveball.
Yep. It has slowed down considerably, but still throwing it. And again, it comes with a high fastball. So you set him up with the curve on the high fastball on the second pitch. Let's see what he does here. If I'm mad, I'm looking curveball, and you just try to follow that fastball off.
Fight it off.
There it is. Oh, a little bit of an off-speed pitch, but it was high. Licks his fingers and rubs the ball up. Full count. You don't want Matt on base right here in front of LaBrie, I'll tell you that. Comes the payoff pitch. Fastball, foul, straight back. Into the river. Ball number five.
Let's go, Matt. Hey, Maddie. Finish him.
Bench chair on Maddie on.
99 pitches.
So here comes pitch number 100. Fastball in the dirt. Ball four.
That's how you work a count right there.
Sure is. Two out walk. That could be costly.
Now batting number 20, Nick LaBrie.
I don't see how they keep
Plymouth
him
coach
in.
Is going out there, yeah. The catcher gave him a fist bump, so that's probably it. Like you said, he's on a short leash. You got the first two outs and the first batter that reaches, and it takes him out of the game. Good job by DeMoss.
100 pitches. He did a great job.
Good hand from the Plymouth fans. Looks like number 3, Mike Hogan going in the pitch. Hogan was at third base. And it looks like DeMoss is going right back out there. No rest for the weary. He's calling in the left fielder. Nope. Where's he going?
Now that looks like for Plymouth, number 3, Mike Hogan.
DeMoss is tired. Look at him. He's out there, hands on his knees. He's pitched a heck of a game.
Well, I'll tell you what. We hit 100 pitches, the 4 runs, 3 Ks, and 4 walks.
7 runs, Paul.
7 runs, sorry. And I'll tell you what, against Goffstown, he should be extremely proud.
That's pretty
good. He pitched a heck of a game.
Sure did.
So right now, he's just watching, paying attention. Let's see what this kid can throw.
He's throwing all fastball so far. I mean, not tearing up the gas here. Probably throwing 75. Looks like he's going to throw a curve here. Let's see. Slow curve. LaBrie's taking it all in.
Yep.
He wants one of those meaty fastballs. Here comes another one. Let's see. There it is.
They give him a fastball. We know Nick, he loves that fastball. He's going to turn and pull it left center, right to the line to left.
So it looks like DeMoss went to second base. And second baseman was Owen Brickley. Looks like he's over at third now. So umpire walking out.
Mike Hogan.
Having Hogan take his batting glove off. Can't pitch with that.
Can't
on
pitch
hand.
That. That's right.
Tells him the situation. Runner on first, 2 down. And you got Nick LaBrie to deal with. Nick's 5'11", 240. Bats right. Throws right. Digging in. Woodward takes off from the base. And Olmstead throws down, and Woodward just gets back. LaBrie was a little ahead of that fastball. Woodward took a big secondary, and Olmstead tried to pick him off.
You know, nice throw. That's what you want. You were a catcher your whole life. That's what you want, right? Throw that down if you think you have that runner.
Yep. Curveball. LaBrie lays off.
Well, he changes his tempo throwing that curveball.
Sure does. You can see it coming. Doesn't look very comfortable throwing it either.
No.
There it is again, up high. So I've seen him throw three of them so far, and they've all been the same. Slow and up high. Hitter's count right here, 2-1. LeBrie's looking fastball. Good count for
him. Can make him pay right here.
There it is, and it's in the dirt, and it gets by Olmstead. Woodward will move up to second base.
Feels like the breeze is coming in now.
Yeah, the flag's not moving, but it definitely feels cooler up here.
I don't know if it's that great fan we have going or if it's, there is a breeze coming off the river.
Fan may have kicked in. Three-one is up high, and he walked him. So really no damage on there. First and second, first base was open. But now you got Hunt up, Peter Hunt.
He's gone to pitcher unassisted, and he struck out.
Looks like Tyler Smalls is going to go in and run for LeBrie.
It's a great move.
Sure is.
Smalls clearly one of the fastest, you know, not just in Goffstown, but definitely in our division.
Pitch running at first base, number one, Tyler Smalls. In batting, number 13, Peter Hunt.
LeBrie did a good job at first base. It means you'll probably see Justin Lou Pernard come into the ballgame.
I would imagine, right? Unless he makes some switches all around and puts Pete Hunt over at first, but I don't know what he's going to do.
We'll see. Big lead over there by Smalls. First baseman not holding him on, of course. Woodward at second. Fastball, strike one.
One thing I love, look at those secondary leads, Mike.
Oh, yeah.
With Matt and Smalls. They're both not afraid to do it. That's baseball smarts.
Well, Smalls is going to go as big as he needs to. Catcher's not going to throw there. If he does, that's kind of a silly throw. There's a ground ball right down the line. Base hit. Past the diving third baseman. Woodward coming around third to score. He'll score easily. And a throw comes in, and it's an errant throw. Picked up by Hogan, the pitcher, throw to third base, and he's safe. And Hunt stays at third base. Great job.
Now batting number seven, Mitch Scacchi.
Now Mitchie, if he can help his cause here, you know, again, that ground ball right down the third base line, great hustle with some speed with Matt and Smalls right there. Puts 90 feet away for another one.
Peter Hunt, great piece of hitting right there, right down the line. That ball was fair by about a foot. Woodward scores easily from second base. Small goes into third on the errant throw from the left fielder. Big lead by Hunt. And he's taken off, pitch in the dirt. Olmstead holds onto it.
No throw. I would have been shocked if he threw, even if it wasn't in the dirt.
Good no throw there. You kind of want to stop the bleeding here.
Well, you end up airmailing that to center field, and Peter Hunt has great speed as well. Two runs could be scoring on that.
Mitch is a good hitter. He'll probably take a strike anyway. He swings and he pops it up to second base. Second baseman under it makes the grab to retire the side. But Goffstown picks up a run. So score at the end of five full is Goffstown 8 and Plymouth 4.
After five innings, Bobcats 4, Grizzlies 8.
I know why it got so cold up here. Probably been joined in the booth by Mitchie's dad, John.
How are you doing back there, John? You're hanging with us.
See, here's the thing. John can't stand it down there. He's all worried. Mitchie's on the mound. So I think as he comes up here, maybe he can kind of hide his emotions a little bit.
Mitchie's going to be facing the top of the order, Mike.
Yep. Hogan, who just came in to pitch, will be leading us off. If we're lucky down the line, we might hear Scocky John on one of our broadcasts coming up in the future.
He's more than welcome. Wednesday, Friday. As Mike, with three boys, between hockey and everything else, he volunteers a lot in Goffstown area. So we're going to be missing him for a couple of games.
Well, if we do a good job and they like us, maybe we'll take this show on the road, too. You never know.
I'll tell you, I've said it before, a couple years ago, Orsillo and Remy were the best they're on, and I'm not seeing them having anything on us right now.
No. Well, Orsillo's out west now. He's with the Padres. Dave O'Brien has nothing on us, Paul.
Huh? No, O'Brien definitely doesn't.
Looks like we got Justin Pernard now at first base.
Okay, just what we called, right?
Now batting number three, Mike Hogan.
I know J-Man's been, his back's been a little tight, but, you know, he's a trooper. He'll get right out there like the rest of Goffstown kids and, you know, grind it out.
There's Mitchie waiting to deliver his first pitch. Ball gets put in play by the umpire, and here we go. Fastball, ground ball to third. That's a fair ball, and it gets by Cody Morrell. Cody thought it was going to go foul. Hogan rounding first base, and he'll stop there with a leadoff base hit. That's a ball Morrell usually handles. I think he was kind of confused. He thought it was going to go foul, but that ball was inside the bag by about 6 inches.
I don't know if he thought it was going to come up or if he thought it was going to maybe kick, you know, to the left, you know, coming out. But
now batting number eight, Owen Brickley.
He knows he's got that, you know, grind in the lip. He knows he wants this ball hit to him to turn that double play.
So Brickley's fourth at bat. He's been hit by a pitch. We'll have to say, here's a ground ball to third. Here's Morrell on the backhand. Makes the long throw across the diamond to first base. Justin keeps the bag. Moves the runner to second base. So two pitches. They're out. They're coming out swinging. Two pitches.
Right.
And we have an out and a man on second base.
They're aggressive. And like I said, I knew Morrell wanted that ball hit to him. And it's fate, right? How many times have we told these kids?
Ball gets hit right back to you.
Come right back at you.
Now batting number seven, Dylan Donahue.
And if you don't want that ball hit to you, you're going to make another error.
It's going to find you.
And then you would have wound up with men on first and third.
Right. Nice curveball, and there's another ground ball. This is hit to Hyzak. Hyzak makes the play, throws the first, two down.
Nice throw right there.
Three pitches, and now we have a runner at third base. Like we said, Mitchie keeps the ball down, and he gets those ground balls, and he had three in a row.
Now batting number 11, Garrett DeMoss.
He knows what he has out there for defense. He lets them work, keeps that, you know, that ground ball. He knows somebody's going to grab it, make that play. That runner at third is really no big issue right now. Let's
no,
get that third
I mean,
out.
Four-run lead, you know, you can just pitch, do your thing, keep throwing strikes. And that's a nice pitch. That's a nice pitch.
And you know what? We've talked about it ad nauseum, you and I, over the years, that I love it when a pitcher can come out and throw breaking ball first pitch.
Mm-hmm.
You're feeling comfortable with everything right there.
He's throwing three fastball first pitches and changed it up.
And then he changed, right?
Now he comes right back with the fastball. So now DeMoss doesn't know what to look for here.
What's coming?
Do you waste one? You throw one in the dirt. You throw one high and outside. Jake, senior catcher, setting up, going outside.
Going outside.
And there's a line drive to left field, and it's over the head of Ethan Smith. Came in a little bit. DeMoss rounding first base, headed for second base. He's going to get in there standing. But it's a two-out double for DeMoss that scores a run.
You know, like we've said with Plymouth, it's that first step. Ethan came in, just you don't have a chance after that.
Now batting number 14, Patrick Ball.
And I know he's great speed, great arm, you know, to recover from that. He was able to keep him on second.
That ball was hit hard. I mean, I was surprised our field is not playing a little further back to prevent against the doubles.
To prevent that.
Mitchie with a high fastball and a strike.
Patrick struck out, and he flew to left, and then went to the pitcher unassisted.
There's a little number hit in front of the plate. That's going to go foul. Jake's got to get on that. And we have two strikes. Mitchie's thrown, one ball so far this inning, right?
Correct.
And he's thrown a lot of strikes. Very productive pitches.
He's done well.
He's thrown three pitches, and he had two outs and a man on third. And then DeMoss, the guy who started the game pitching for Plymouth, put one over Ethan Smith's head. Mitchie's going to come in here. Low fastball, another ground ball foul at the plate. Count remains 0-2.
No emotion out there.
None.
He keeps that in check. That's you know, sometimes you can't teach that. That's
right.
Something he's doing on his own. He knows, hey, I have a man on second. I'm in control of this game right now.
It's right.
Pitching great.
He's not going to tie it here. He steps off, keeping that runner close at second base. Resets his cap, steps back in, looks in for the sign. Looks to second. Here's the pitch. Curveball just fouled off. Very defensive swing by Malm, but got a piece of it. Wasn't expecting that curveball. Did a good job of fouling it off there. Still has him 0-2.
He's going to own him right here.
Fastball inside. Turns him back.
Wow. He had a little extra on that, and I liked it.
Sure did.
I don't think Mom wasn't expecting that.
Was not. Comes back. Another fastball in the dirt. Nice stop
Good
by
stop.
Jake. Count even now at 2-2. See if Mitchie trusts that curveball here. Be a good spot. Don't need to throw him a fastball. He does, and he
just
goes outside. Now it's full. Got Quayle on deck. Full count. Mitchie looks in, comes to the stretch. There's the pitch. Fastball.
There you
strike
go.
Three called.
That. I'll tell you what.
That'll end the inning.
Mitchie did a heck of a job recomposing himself there. More pitches he's thrown in that batter than the other three combined.
So scored the end of 5.5, 8-5, Goffstown.
13 pitch inning. He's got 38.
38 over three innings. That's pretty efficient.
But, you know, I liked what he did there. He knew, okay, this batter's making me work, and I'm going to win. And he stuck it out, and he won that battle.
Sure did. Hogan making his way back out to the mound.
Well, I'll tell you what, Hogan's definitely going to be facing top of the lineup, so we'll see how he does there, how patient our top of our lineup's going to be. Are we going to make this kid pitch? But it looks like Ethan Smith is coming out. It looks like that is
Nick Madison
coming in. Number 11, Nick Madison. Nick's a senior, plays catcher, second base, outfield. He's a switch hitter.
Looks up and waves to you, Paul.
He's a man of many talents down there.
Now batting number 11, Nick Madison.
He gets a little cheer from the crowd. Nick works hard, always has, does everything that's expected. And then some.
Hogan looks in for the sign. And he delivers. High fastball, ball one. Pitch, fastball up high, foul back.
I don't know if you noticed, Mike, but if you look at Cody Morrell, Jacob Hunt, Nick Madison, they all go to the old-fashioned stirrups.
Oh, yeah.
One old school. I kind of liked it.
Yep.
Better than those long pants that, you know, came about, what was it, maybe late 80s, early 90s, started to take fame.
High curveball for a ball, 2-1. Yeah, kind of old school myself. I'd go for the stirrups.
Agreed.
Fastball, line drive, base hit, right
Contact
field.
Contact hit right there.
Nice job by Madison, going where the pitch is thrown.
Right.
Good speed. And we run on first with no outs.
Now batting number 14, Clay Campbell.
Campbell's 2-for-3 in the day. Madison's got good speed over there. Small lead right now. Jumps out, big lead, big secondary
lead.
Huh? Call strike
wow.
And a curveball. Big secondary, but Olmstead looking down at his first baseman, so you may see him throw here.
Absolutely. Not. He threw it out last
again.
Inning, right?
Sure did, but Woodward on base. Madison jumping out again. Look, big, big lead. Slow curve in the dirt. Not a good pitch for Olmstead to throw down on. So if he gets a fastball inside here where he can handle, wouldn't be surprised he has snapped it on the third.
looked at the coach. He just told him to throw to first. I mean, he was pretty obvious with telling him to throw. Look at the change in the catcher stance.
Look at the lead. Right? Look at the lead. And pitch in the dirt again. Olmstead comes out, bluffs down to first base. I think if he had a good pitch there, he would have threw it.
Yeah, I agree. He wants him to throw. Coach, again, just gave him, tell him to throw it on.
Well, you got to trust the catcher.
Yes, you do.
Right fielder is way off the line, though. There's a ground ball right to first. That's a foul ball. Good call by the home plate umpire.
He's right on it. They've done a great job today.
Could have been a possible double play ball, too. Great job by the umpire calling that foul. 2-2 count now. Madison's got to watch himself here.
You don't want a strikeout throw out here, you know, especially going back down to first.
Madison, huge second hit. Campbell way ahead of the curveball. First baseman running over, and that's out of play. Still a 2-2 count. I feel a little breeze coming in here.
Feels good.
Campbell got a break there. He lunged for a curveball way out ahead of. Fouled it off. Madison still jumping around. High fast. There's the throw that we knew was coming. Just back safely.
You knew that was coming.
Tell you, good throw. He might have had him. I mean, it's tough. It's tough on the catcher with the lefty in the box, so he's got to throw around him. But
the count is full.
What if Madison goes here? Full count. He's been getting a huge secondary lead. Nope, he stays. Fastball, low fastball, foul down the left field line. Third baseman looking over, and that's going to get out of play. Count remains full. Tell you what, Madison's secondary lead, the pitcher is not throwing over
there. Not throwing over at all.
I'd throw over. I mean, he goes short, and then he just hops
out. He does that hop, right.
He does the hop. I mean, if you catch him in that hop, you're going to pick him off. Like right now is where I throw it. There he goes.
There he goes.
And there's a ground ball through the hole. Base hit. Third hit of the day for Campbell. Madison rounding second base. He's going to be held up at second. And we have first and second with no outs.
Now batting number five, Connor Isaac.
Third hit of the game for Campbell. Not hit hard, but right through the hole.
It was effective. It's what you want.
It's all you need to do. Stay down on the fastball. The first baseman holding him on.
Don is way out in the box. He's changed again. He knows this kid's throwing slow for him.
And a curveball for a strike. First baseman's playing in front of Campbell. I don't know why. If you're going to play there, you might as well hold him on. I don't understand that positioning right there. It's not like
and the Isaac's, coaches aren't even looking at him.
Not like Isaac's going to bunt.
Nope.
A three-hitter. Curveball, and he hits a fly ball to center field. Center fielder camping under it. Madison tagging. Makes the grab, no advancement. Good throw into the shortstop. Isaac just got under that one.
No batting, number eight, Cody Morrell.
So Morrell can make amends here for not having a great day. He can runners on first. He's come up with a lot of runners on base today.
He is. The ducks in the pond, as we say.
First and second.
I know he's frustrated, but you want to know what? He's going to be tough on himself.
First pitch curveball outside for a strike. Logan likes that first pitch curveball. He's thrown it three times now. It's a slow curve, kind of hard to lay off. Cody's a much better hitter than that. I think he's sitting fastball here, though. He gets it, and he swings and misses. He was looking for the fastball. You could tell that pitch was low in the dirt, and he swung anyway. He was gearing up for a fastball. If I'm Hogan here, I use a waste pitch here, either in the dirt with a curve or a high fastball. Don't give me anything close.
Yep.
Catcher sitting up way outside. He throws a fastball outside. That's definitely a waste pitch. Olmstead wasn't even in the strike zone. And you went outside with that. Now you come low and inside with a curveball maybe. Nope. Catcher setting up outside again, but going low. There's the curve in the dirt. There's a line drive, base hit to right field. Madison's rounding third base. He's coming. He's being held up by the third base coach as the throw comes in, and we have bases loaded with one out.
Now batting number 18, Jake Hunt.
Morrell sat back on that curveball. Curveball was lowing in, and he just hit a line drive, base hit to right field. And now we have Jake Hunt coming up with the bases loaded and one out.
Again, somebody who's had a very frustrating day. you know. But we just saw Cody snap out of his day and went with that pitch, nice in the gap between first and second.
I'm not sure that's where Hogan wanted to throw it though. 1-2, I think he wanted to throw that pitch down a little further in the dirt. Olmstead was setting up down. That's too good of a pitch. I know it's a curveball, but that's still too good of a pitch to throw there on a 1-2 count to the number four hitter. Jake now has a chance to come up big for Goffstown. 8-5 lead. Not insurmountable by any stretch.
As long as he doesn't try to do too much with one swing. Just make contact and drive the ball. You know, that'll help get you out of your little funk, you know.
That's it. You got it right. I mean, you got the bases loaded. A base hit probably scores two. You got Campbell on second base.
Good, decent speed. Good,
Speed. I mean, you know, that ball's hit to right field. Third base coach Adam Lawrence playing it safe by not sending Madison. He may have had it.
Infield's
got to play in, yep. So that opens it up more for Jake. You know, little punch and Judy could be what he needs here out of this. Left fielder playing very close to the line. He's got a huge gap in left center field. You only remember your last at bat, Paul.
That's right.
You could make up for the day right
here.
He would
have to end his frustration, which you hope to see happen.
Fastball on the dirt ball one. He's going from the windup, so Madison's taking his liberties over there at third base. Come down as far as he needs to.
Smart move. I mean, you know, Campbell could take a huge secondary.
Baseman's playing in, so the catcher's not going to throw behind you in this instance. Campbell, if I was Campbell, I'd be 60 feet off the base right now. Same thing with Morrell at
there
first.
There you go, right?
And he's way ahead of a fastball, and he follows it straight back. He'd like to have that one back. He just missed that one.
Yeah. Again, he's trying to do it all with one swing, but it's all right. Yep. Went straight back. He didn't miss by much.
Now, when he's on, that ball's crushed right there. He's just he's got to get his timing.
Yep, that's exactly right. It's just
Campbell's got to come further off the bag there. Now he starts
to
move away. Curveball for a strike. Nice pitch.
Nice pitch right there.
That's a great pitch, but
glad he didn't swing. You don't want to swing. He did that last time. He swung with one strike on a curveball and ended up popping up. So make him throw it again, or you know, maybe get that fastball.
Yeah, I wouldn't throw the fastball here if I was Hogan.
No. Not with a 1-2 count.
Curveball fouled off. Good fight there by Jake. That was a good curveball, almost the same spot as the last pitch, and he fought it off, fouled it straight back.
Well, a little battle. He's got to win this. He's in the hole. He's got to dig himself out.
Yep. Again, Hogan's got to be smart. Hogan and Olmstead's got to be smart here.
Opportunity's knocking.
They're not even looking at Madison, though. I tell you, he can come halfway down the line. There's the pitch in the dirt. 2-2. Right where Jake wants to be.
Changes things up a little bit right now.
Yep, that was a fastball. Again, you have to look for that curveball. It's slow. You just have to wait on it. Here comes the pitch, and it's a fastball in the dirt, and now he's full.
Tell you what, walks as good as a hit, and it drives in a run.
Sure does.
So be smart here, right? Especially with one out.
Yep, and you got Matt Woodward on deck. Already doubled in a couple runs.
Right.
Does Hogan throw the curveball on a full count? Let's see. I'm Jake. I got to be sitting on that fastball, but you have to adjust to the curve. Here it comes. Fastball foul straight back. Just missed.
Wow.
Oh, look at Jake's face. He wants that one back. Smacking his lips there. He knows he just missed that one. You know, he's going to sit there saying to himself, he's not going to throw the ball by me. He doesn't have that kind of heat.
Right.
Just sit back.
Just sit back.
Look for the fastball and adjust to the curve and just follow the curve off. That's not the ball you want to put in play. That's the one you want to follow off. Here comes the pitch. Fastball low, and he walked him. And that's going to walk in a run. That's going to make it 9-5 Goffstown.
Now batting number 21, Matt Woodward.
And I'll tell you what, Matt has been getting hot, not just on the mound, but in hitting. And this is just not getting any easier for Plymouth right now.
No. Nope. Matt's been on base three times today, walked twice and doubled. A couple of ribbies. And Matty calls timeout. Campbell at third, Morrell at second, Hunt at first. Got some, not as much speed, but you got very intelligent base runners out there. I mean, Morrell's at second base. He'll get a big secondary, so will Jake. First pitch, fastball down low for a ball. Count is 1-0.
Matt's a smart hitter. He knows right now it'll make him pitch to him.
Right. Don't fall for that curveball.
Nope. His fastball is not hitting. Just sit back.
He's been low with his fastball. He is keeping the ball down. You got to give him that. There it is. Fastball up high. There's a base hit to left. That was crushed. Where's he going to hit the gap? No, it's cut off by the left fielder. Morrell's coming around third base to cut the shortstop. They throw to the plate. He is safe.
Safe.
And Jake moves up to third, and smart Matt stays running at second base. Good base running. That'll score two, and it's 11-5 Goffstown.
Yeah. Justin Pinard.
Now batting number nine, Justin Pinard.
You know, Jake Hunt taking off for third as soon as that throw went in to the catcher. Again, just baseball move. Great hit by Matt Woodward. The odds are really good right now. He's going to take off for second.
Yeah, I mean, he's not being held on. The first baseman's playing in front of him. He's not being held on. It just now he moves back to take him out, to hold him on, because the catcher's yelling out the signal. But, you know, right there, the only thing that I would have done, Matty should have, the first base coach, when the throw came in, Matt should have taken off for second base.
Agreed.
We should have
Agreed.
Second and third right now, but
yep.
I think that'll correct itself in a minute. Matt's got a big lead there. Lou digging in.
They're giving him, again, the way they're
outfield. There he goes.
Playing.
Matt takes off. Slow curve. No throw.
No throw.
Looks back to first. Oh, I'm sorry. That was a ball, a strike. We have one strike count to Justin Pinard. I can't help calling him Lou. I've been calling him Lou since he was 9 years old.
Just
infield's
a good
coming
kid.
In here. Second and third.
Second and third.
One out, and the infield's coming in. I guess they don't want this game to get away.
This is Justin's field right now.
Slow curve, and
there
Justin hits
that's
a slooper.
Drop.
That's going to fall left center field. Why are the runners going back? I don't know. Jake scores. Matt's being held up, and we have first and third still with one out. And it's 12-5 Goffstown. That's Nolan Gamet. Nolan coming in to pinch hit.
Now batting number three, Nolan Gamet.
Well, I'll tell you what. Nolan, as we know, his nickname is Nails. And he had a ball. His father had, I know you remember this, during All-Stars, had suffered a heart attack and missed practice. And he took a ground ball off the nose. Remember that?
Same day.
How are we going to tell his wife that his son just broke his nose? But he's as tough as nails, this kid.
Sure is.
Good kid.
Fastball for a strike.
Nolan is known just that he's that fastball hitter. He'll take that. He'll pull it. He's not afraid. He won't bail out.
He's been doing that same routine at the plate since he was in Little League 2. Keeps that 1 foot out, taps the plate, comes in there, holds those hands high.
Nice curveball right there.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was a strike. Thought that pitch was a little high. So Nolan keeps 1 foot out, hits the plate, rolls the bat, stands up there, hands high. 0-2 count. First and third, one out. Justin staying at first base. Fastball low. 1-2. Hogan really laboring this inning.
He is, and he has right now he throws a fastball. I could see Nolan just going even to that right center field. The way they're playing that outfield, I don't know.
Throws a curveball that stays high. 2-2. Outfield's playing extremely deep, but the left fielder is like –
I don't even see
literally him. 20 feet down the third bit, down the left field line, and there's a gap.
That left center field is wide open.
The right fielder's playing a good 50, 60 feet up the line. The left fielder, not so much. Another pitch in the dirt. Good stop.
Nice stop.
By Olmstead back there. Now the count runs full. 12-5 Goffstown. First and third, full count, one out. Mitch Skocke on deck. Fastball strike three. High fastball got him. Nolan wants that one back.
He does. He's frustrated, but, you know, it's that might be his second at bat, I believe, for the season.
So here comes Mitch with two outs. Runners on first and third. Trying to add a little more insurance here. Seven-run Goffstown lead. Justin with a decent-sized lead over there at first base. Doesn't go. Mitchie takes a strike. Hogan pours in a fastball right there. Good pitch. You know, he's going to remember who he's dealing with here. Nine-hitter, pitcher. Probably doesn't want to run around too much. Comes up high with a fastball.
And you're absolutely right, and that's something that even coaches should be yelling out to him, or his catcher, letting him know who he's at, who he's facing, if the pitcher himself forgets.
DeMoss is fidgeting with his hand out there. He doesn't have his glove on right now. Another high fastball, 2-1.
You know, in a matter of an inning, some kids just all of a sudden lose interest, right? They get frustrated, already beaten, but why make things worse? That ball's going to find you. We talked about it earlier.
Yep. And that's three straight high fastballs to Mitch. And the count's now 3-1 with Madison on deck, who looks like he's swinging the bat left-handed. May come up left-handed this next time. Does like the bat, does like the switch. He's gotten much better as a left.
Nice contact hitter. Hands to the ball.
And Mitch with a defensive swing on a 3-1 pitch for full count. Not sure what he was looking for there. He had a fastball right down Broadway. Mitch hasn't had very many at-bats this year. Full count. Runner will be off. Justin will be running. Big lead, and there he goes, and he fouls it off. Justin will have to do it all over again. Hears it from his teammates on the bench.
All in good fun. The kid always has a smile on his face, right?
Yep. 12-5 Goffstown, first and third, full count. Mitch Skocke at the plate, two outs. Mitch digging in, not even holding Justin on now. He takes off. There he goes. High fastball, struck him out. And that'll retire the side. But after six full, it is Goffstown 12 and Plymouth 5.
After six innings, Plymouth 5, Goffstown 12.
As we come out to top seven, we have a defensive change here. Tyler Santoro heading out to second base in place of Clay Campbell.
And I'll tell you what, we talked about earlier. That was 40 pitches thrown
wow.
in that inning right there. That's a lot of pitches for a young kid.
And he didn't throw many the inning before.
No. We had eight pitches when he came in,
yep.
and he threw 40 there.
Gamet hustling out to right field. Taking over in right for Peter Hunt. Nick Madison goes to left. Matt Woodward in center. Still got the Moose at third. Clay Campbell goes to short. Hizak is now out of the game. Mitchie still on the mound. Justin Pernard at first. And Jake still behind the dish.
And we have 6, 7, and 8 coming up. I think the bottom of their order, you know, they produced a little bit early, but after that, they've struggled at the plate, a lot of strikeouts. If Mitchie keeps the ball low, we could have ourselves a quick inning here.
Now batting number 4, Nick Qualley.
Nick batting from the left side. Had a pretty good day today. Struck out. He flew out. He reached on an error. He was the one who started that second inning with Hizak. But he's seen a lot of pitches today. He's gone full a couple times. Made the pitcher work.
He has. His last two at-bats, he brought it both to full count. And in the third inning, he made Hizak work a lot.
There's a fastball and a pop-up. Morrell running. Going to go out of play.
But that's what you want. He did the right thing then. You know, Connor was struggling a little bit. So they said, okay, I'm sure the coach was telling him, let's see some pitches here. Don't just go up there hacking.
You know, and it was his hustle. I mean, he hits a one-hopper back to the mound, and if he doesn't run that out and Hizak doesn't have to rush his throw and he
right.
makes a good throw to Labrie, and that four-run inning doesn't happen. So you got to give him some credit there.
Absolutely.
Fastball, strike two.
You can't coach hustle, right? You can't coach that.
I mean, his at-bat, you know, doesn't look so much. I mean, reaching on an error, strikeout, and but he's had he's put up some good at-bats, and he's hustled. And he started that whole first inning. 2-2 count. Mitch working quickly. Fastball outside, full count. Clouds are starting to cover the sun. It's starting to cool off a little bit.
Feels great.
Feels
we were
great
sitting in the
up
sun
here.
Those first four innings.
We're in the shade right now, but comes the pitch by Mitch. In the dirt, but he gets him the
nice
swing
pitch.
And miss. Strike three. Good pitch by Mitch right there.
Now batting number 19, Ryan Finkel.
Ryan Finkel batting for Olmstead here. So Olmstead may have caught everything, but he's not hitting here. And there's a check swing foul, strike one.
Yeah, Olmstead definitely had a tough day at the plate. Two strikeouts, one walk. Behind, you know, defensively, they made him work a little bit. You know, he did great blocking. Makes for a long day. And now let's see if this if Finkel can help get Plymouth going.
Fastball inside for a ball, 1-1. Mitch working quickly. Finkel, big kid. Fastball inside again. Just missed. 2-1 count. Finkel twirls the bat a couple times. Fastball, swing and a miss. Big cut.
It's a nice pitch. You saw Mitchie bear down on that one. He kept it low and inside. It was a nice pitch.
Tell you, Mitchie keeps the ball down so much. Here
back
it comes.
Back inside.
And a low fastball, ground ball. Morrell charges it. Easy play. Makes the
all
throw
day.
To Pernard. Makes it look easy, doesn't he?
All day right there. Took his time. Did the right thing. Played it well.
So the coaches of Plymouth State are looking at. So this is Mitch's fourth inning on the mound.
Now batting number 9, Dan Carey.
Hizak went the first three and was responsible for all the runs. I'm sorry, Mitch let up one. There's a ground ball to second base.
Santoro
makes the play, and that's the ball game. A great job right there by Goffstown. And that'll end it as they come off the field.
Final score, Plymouth 5, Goffstown 12.
12-5 win for Goffstown, making them 4-0 on the young season now. And Plymouth falls to 2-2. Great job by Mitch. Mitch goes four innings, allows just the one run, I believe.
Two Ks. Mitch did extremely well, kept the ball low, like we talked. No walks. The walks, he didn't get in trouble.
No.
So that was huge.
And that's something that he does well. He throws strikes. He keeps the ball down. You know, four innings. What did he throw, 40-something pitches?
50, exactly.
50 pitches, exactly. And Hizak threw, 78 through 3. So great game. Paul, great working with you today.
We'll good be luck back with at it. Mission next couple of games.
Good luck with whomever is going to cover for us in the booth. And as we sign off today, once again, we'll zoom in on that scoreboard out there and just show you. Goffstown 12-5 winners over Plymouth State. For Paul Hunt, I'm Mike Santoro saying thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.